The nominees is
All
an
right.
inclusive group of talented
And
actors
this
filling
is
vastly
the
different roles
Game
in games that
section
are
of my
nothing
recording.
alike.
This is
However,
not 100%
these artists
live.
are
I am
nominated
missing
tonight for what
a
they
little
share
bit
in
of the
common,
beginning.
a
I
clear
just had my
dedication to
top
their
10 moments
craft,
and stuff
and
that
an
came out this year.
extraordinary ability to
I
bring
feel like this
humanity
is now
and empathy
super
to their
loud, so I'm
roles.
going to put it
Here
down a
are the
bit.
nominees for best performance.
Best performance.
Okay. Sorry about that. Matter of fact, I wonder if there's like a way that I could see this Smash character trailer without seeing it, you know? Oh well, I don't know.
Okay, let's do this.
This is so weird how like it's just everyone on the stage and shit. Weird how she gets it too.
Oh,
was that Laura Bailey that won it?
Oh wow.
Yeah, oh wow, shit. She was fucking she did win. Wow.
I
Is it still loud or should I should I lower it?
Last of Us and of Troy and Ashley's performances within it.
I'm going to tone it down just a tad.
With Joel Minnelli. So it is no surprise.
It's lower now. Okay, okay.
Abby's role within
let's try here.
Has been met with such passionate responses.
Yeah, in the meantime,
but,
let me see if I can find this this trailer without
such
super,
a fantastically challenging character.
I'm probably gonna see like the spoiler of it, but
enables the player to find forgiveness and empathy is something that
I'll
be eternally grateful
for. I don't
know if I
can actually see it. This is gonna be weird.
I told the team on the day that I finished filming that what I wanted more than anything was for
these
performance
aren't.
To.
I'm gonna see if I could get my brother to find it.
Honored the impact that the original game had on me, so this award means so much.
Yeah, I'm gonna see if my brother can help me out.
Thank you to Neil and Tally and the entire
team.
Yeah,
hold on. While she talks about how well she did in
the
game, that doesn't matter. Let me go see if my brother can help me when the stream's over. So give me a second.
Patrick and Ian.
Well, not that the stream is over, but when the game awards is over, I'm gonna have him come to
the
computer and then put it up as full screen, and then I'm gonna have a full reaction. That's the best way for me to see it. So give me a minute.
To Troy, who through our, I don't know, decades of working together in this industry, we've been allies, we've been enemies, and we've been everything in between. And every single time I work with you, I come away better for it. Thank you for always having my back. And to Ashley, who I love so much. I don't know what else to say other than I think you should probably be giving the speech right now. I think you're amazing, and your strength and your power and your vulnerability and your performance left me speechless. I love you. Marry me. To my husband, Travis, who spent countless hours just listening to me come to terms with what this game's journey has been. And to the fans. Obviously, to everyone who voted, thank
okay,
you.
Okay, nah, he's gonna help. He's
for
gonna
your
help.
Love
so.
And for your passion and for
it'll be at the end of the game awards. So whenever Game of the Year is shown, that's
thank
basically
you.
You know.
I love you.
That's all that's gonna happen. It's just the Game of the Year, and then they won't have anything else extra. So,
congratulations.
When that's done, we'll see
that. Coming in for people congratulating as that was going on. It's
again, this is
so
weird that the fact that he's still doing it at the theater when nobody's there.
We are streaming on every platform tonight, including Twitch, where we have drops for Among Us and Fortnite, who both have world premieres coming up later in the show and throughout the night. We will also be interactive.
I should
Twitch.
Probably be watching on Twitch or whatever so I can get the Among Us shit,
extension.
But that's okay.
First up, best ongoing game, so go and vote now. Lock in your predictions. All right, well, even with everything going on, it's been one of those special years that sees the launch of new next-gen consoles. And with that,
yay,
Devil May
Cry 5 machine
of games.
Pretty
tonight,
much.
We are honored to have one team, a new team of veterans, reveal the very first details about their ambitious and exciting new project right here at the Game Awards. Enjoy.
All right. Oh, just full on premiere. Okay, cool.
Pretty much since the day I started, there's been a really clear.
I'm not familiar with
fantasy.
This guy.
I think the thing that makes it different from a lot of first person games is it's not just
first
about
person.
Shooting.
Eco sci-fi is a term that we use.
Future fiction, but from an ecological focus.
There's been this ecological disaster.
These corporations came in and they developed new technology, and on the surface, everything's Everything's pretty great.
We're still early in development, but we're really excited with where things are going.
We wanted to share...
I don't know any of these guys, so I'm not really familiar with this team. I mean, I'm sure, like, they're keeping that a secret for a reason. Like, the red aesthetic. The Initiative. It's not... That's a team? Not familiar. Yeah, he said he's changed. Dude, I'm fucking hungry too.
The floods. The storms.
Huh?
The fires.
Oh. I thought he said flood, like as in like Halo flood. I was like, huh? How's that? What? He said eco too, like eco first person.
Solutions. A better word.
Mac 4, baby. It's so good it skips 3.
And we welcome them into our lives.
It's not Beyond Good and Evil 2, is it? Because that shit has been like in the fucking sleeps forever.
We need to know what they're hiding.
Not really getting. If it's like a brand new franchise, then yeah, sure. But CG trailers don't really do much when it's like a brand new thing for me. Like, I have to see gameplay, but eco first person, whatever. I don't know what that is. I thought that was like a logo for something.
Did you find the answers you were looking for?
It's not Hitman.
Agent Dark.
Oh, hey, it's not dead. Yeah, good for you, people. Wow. Hey, happy for people who like Perfect Dark. I've never played any of them, so obviously, so most likely PC and Xbox.
There you go, Perfect Dark from the Initiative, Xbox. Very exciting to have that announced. All right, well. We're going to go right into another game.
Perfect Dark was basically a game that was like GoldenEye. It was by the same team back in the day. So GoldenEye 007 came out, and then they made that, Perfect Dark. And people loved it. There was supposed to be another Perfect Dark game, but that got canned, I believe, like at the beginning of the Xbox One cycle. I could be wrong about that, but I do remember something saying that, Perfect Dark's coming back, and now it's not. And now it's back again. So, hey. They'll never just let shit go. Turtle Rock. Dead Island! Dead Island 2's... Dude, if this is a fucking Dead Island 2, I'm not gonna be excited, but I wanna try and find out how long ago.
No worm-ridden son of a bitch is gonna stop us.
Oh my fucking god!
Fire up, handsome.
Yup. Do it. You're new! What is that?
What the hell? Cover me!
I can't believe it. I legit can't fucking believe it. Oh, that looks so good!
Take it out.
Oh man, this is my favorite hoodie.
A little club soda will take that right out.
Watch out!
Back for Blood, and I'm now joined by Chris Ashton of Turtle Rock Studios. This is pretty exciting for all us Left 4 Dead fans. Of course, you guys are known for all the amazing work Left 4 Dead, and now you're building building on the legacy with this new zombie co-op shooter. What's new? What can you tell us about it, Chris?
Well, we wanted to do more and bigger, right? We wanted to have more playable characters, more missions.
You know what?
More story.
It's not
but we also wanted
called
to have a
Left 4 Dead
of zombies to fight, right?
But it's Left 4 Dead. So
bigger.
You know what?
So now we've got these 20
I'm happy.
Tall,
I'm happy for that. Get, just make it brand new. Don't even give it the title,
take,
but
you know, the help
be
of
what it is. So
to defeat.
I'm fine with that.
All right,
I'm
well,
totally
it's
fine
great
with
to have
that.
This game announced, but
what's going on, Y10 the Twitch? What's going on, man? Sorry, I
kind of
had a little nervous breakdown there for a second cuz legit I'm watching Left 4 Dead 3 come through life. But it's just it's a brand new game. So
okay, here we go. Here's the
they bring the 4 back from Left 4
Blood.
Dead, so
thanks,
that's neat. Pre-alpha, obviously. I'm of course gonna get this on PC for sure. Safe rooms. This is so obvious. This is yeah. This is it. Yeah, this is just fucking Left 4 Dead. This is just. Okay. Oh, I'm so happy.
Ready? Not one for speeches. So how about we just go kill some Rick?
Nice pep talk.
Ha, damn. Here we go.
Look at them pop over. Oh, my God. This looks great.
Watch out!
This is still pre-alpha, but, like, this is nicely presented.
I got a bullet for you! And you! And you!
Okay, that can get annoying for, like, the characters constantly talking like that. I mean, they did it in Left 4 Dead, but I wouldn't want to play this guy. What the hell's that? Oh, whoa, look at that. That looks like a fucking Doom demon, like.
Cover me, reloading. Thanks, Holly.
Holly? Okay, that's one of them. Is this like a Crash Bandicoot run away from the thing? Like you can't really fight it until the end?
Need to finish them off and fast.
There's a sprint, so there's that.
Do these guys ever take a vacation?
Okay, here's the thing. How is the versus mode gonna play? Okay, that's all we get, but that's fine. That's all we get. Well, as far as like the, you know, cinematic storytelling of it or whatever, now it's just all like kablamzos. An M1 Garand? What? Why is an M1 Garand in the fucking, I'm gonna use that all the time. Like, what? June 22nd, PS5, PS4, Steam. Did it say Xbox there? I don't remember seeing Xbox. 12:17, 10 a.m. for a live showcase. I don't think I'm actually going to watch that, but hey.
There you go. Back for Blood, June next year. Alpha next week. Crazy. All right.
Oh,
very
full
exciting.
On Alpha.
Well, tonight we're celebrating.
Oh, that's
games,
the Alpha.
And we've got awesome
oh, shit.
Discounts on many of tonight's nominees with the Game Awards
actually
sale
play that.
Across Xbox, PlayStation, Nintendo eShop, Epic Games Store, and Steam. And we also have the Game Awards Festival, a chance to play upcoming games like Little Nightmares 2. And some of the games are also available
someone just broke something
instantly
upstairs.
With GeForce Now. So make sure to check that out. You can stream on any device with no downloads on GeForce Now. Well, we also have a lot of great stuff coming up. We'll have performances from the London Philharmonic Orchestra and
London
Eddie
Philharmonic.
Vedder.
I actually
right
saw them
now,
with
ago, we
my brother is
at the Game
way into music, obviously.
From
and we saw like a lot of like
everyone
performances
has been wondering
for them too.
When
and I think he saw them like twice.
For news on
so.
That. Let's hear from Midwinners, Josh Holmes.
Thanks, Jeff. I do have a really exciting update for you, but
okay.
First, I just want to thank the many thousands of players who've been.
Honestly, I don't want to look at like any other
year.
Site or anything
your
because I might get spoiled by the Smash character.
The world to us. We couldn't do this without you. But today.
Yeah, I shouldn't look away from the screen. Or at least this one. I was gonna like look at maybe Discord, but
Explorers.
I'm sure that someone's already said something on it. I don't want to get spoiled. So.
You'll face off against many others.
I don't know what this is.
There are countless strategies and paths to success.
Ooh.
Find the ones that get you back alive.
This is where the real fun starts.
I've been preparing this for
There's
years.
There's something about, like, showing off that you can
now,
use a bow and arrow while there's shooting going on that just kind of helps out, like, me get interested in something. I just like that where it's like, oh, is it just another shooty shoot? Yeah, but we also have this, we have this. It's like, that actually is, like, more interesting than just, here's different types of just shoot 'em up things, you know?
Your test begins now.
Oh, I didn't change the, I didn't change the things here, so.
All right, so there you have it. The PC closed beta for Scavengers starts right now. If you're part of our community, you can play with your existing Steam key. But we're also opening up 50,000 slots for new players. So go to playscavengers.com,
and it should be,
sign up for
special
free,
events.
And we'll see you in the game.
Or just events. I thought it was special events. Why is this Dark Souls? I can't really seem to find the special event counter. Oh well. I mean, that's not really a huge deal. It's still technically on just chat, so that's fine. Oh, it looks like it's a multiplayer thing. That's fine. Let's just make sure my refresh is right. Eh. Hood. Oh, I live in the hood. Not quite, but yeah. Outlaws and Legends. Yeah, it looks like it's gonna be another one of those like Raid Shadow Legends things where it's like that's gonna be the most promoted thing ever. Indies, yay! Give me that. Give me more indies on Switch. Is that Hades, Cuphead, Goose Game? Yep. I still need to fucking play Hades. Everyone says it's fucking good, so. Stardew Valley, yep. I still need to. I don't know if I would really like that type of gameplay though. I guess it's just like a B-roll footage of like, oh, here's actually what's on Switch, so you may as well just get it on Switch. Ugh. Excuse me, I couldn't gush enough about you in a second. Hey. Yay, thank you to the indie partners. Nintendo's still being a shit, though.
But you can't! Anyways, Instagram and the Game Awards have teamed up for 6 new AR effects you can share to Instagram Reels. I played with them yesterday.
I don't know what the hell Instagram is. I'm not an Insti.
Check it out. You can transport yourself to Final Fantasy VII's train station, transform into the Doom Slayer, don the mask of the Ghost of Tsushima, sneak through The Last of Us, or even become Zagreus.
I'm a nerd, not a fucking dweeb.
To create your own, just head like, over to the Game Awards on
thank
Instagram.
Thank God I don't actually have an Instagram.
Icon
nobody would want
to
see that.
Instagram
but I should have a.
Later to
everyone keeps saying that
I
should be good with a fucking Logan Instagram. I was thinking of that, but I want to subject myself to do shit like that. Come on. Forza Horizon 4, this was like 3 years ago now. Apparently they're supposed to do some sort of like Cyberpunk collaboration, I think. Horizon's actually a good game, but you know, all on Xbox, so. You know what, I'd think about it, yeah. I guess. It won't really hurt me. It'll just keep adding my brownie points for Logan.
There you go, Forza cross Cyberpunk and.
Oh yeah,
later,
there's the
Keanu
Jeff Keighley.
Reeves,
I'm still gonna wear a suit, but wear my Jordans.
To present the best direction awards, so stay tuned for that. But welcome back. Now coming up next, we're gonna present the best ongoing game award, and the Twitch community thinks Fortnite is gonna win that with 47% of the votes. Well,
makes
let's
sense.
Find out the Twitch community is right. We are going to present the best ongoing game, which recognizes 5 outstanding titles that continue to deliver.
Fortnite is outstanding.
Here are the nominees.
best ongoing game.
Yeah, Apex. People still play Apex? I thought that shit died. Warzone, yeah, people are still playing it. I'm not playing it anymore, though. Destiny 2? I want Destiny 2 to win. Only because it makes CB happy, I guess. He won't stop fucking raving about it. No Man's Sky. Ah, you know what? No Man's Sky has fallen from grace, and now it's, like, actually a really good game. So, I'll say, Oh, there he is! There he is! Fucking huge liar man right in the corner. Fucking Hello Games. There he is.
The winner is... The Game Award goes to No Man's Sky.
Oh! Oh, what? What? I'm legit surprised. Wow, Sean Murray. Wow.
It's normally... Twitch is right, Jeff. It's normally Fortnite. It's always Fortnite that beats us. Thank you so much.
You know what? I'm happy. Really, I'm actually kind of happy about that. No Man's Sky was absolutely fucking terrible when it came out. But you know what?
It's not always easy, though.
That's not going to justify it. So I will find the video to justify it. I hope I don't get spoiled by finding it. Internet historian.
Thank you so much.
No Man's Sky. This video absolutely helps it out. Like, to really go over the history of what happened with No Man's Sky.
Sean Murray, No Man's
so,
Sky, best
you know what?
Game.
They fucking deserve it. They deserve an award.
The show, there's always
so,
a lot of speculation,
if anyone
a lot of
that's,
games
you know, hasn't seen or doesn't know the history of No Man's Sky or whatever, just blew right past them, definitely like take a look one. At Check Internet Historian's video because it covers basically every aspect of it. That, you know what? The fucking studio deserves it, even though, like, they fucked up, but... At the very least, they have made a video game that actually is playable and it works and it's good. So, big ups to them for, like, literally just putting in all the stops to make sure No Man's Sky is a good game. So, I legit got fucking surprised there. Whoa, okay, Dead Space fucking feels right now. Either that or Remember Me with the little fucking discs or whatever. I didn't get a chance to play that. But...
Get up.
He's gonna be dead already. Watch, watch, watch. Calling it. What the hell? Hey! That's what I said. You're allowed.
Are you seeing this? Something ain't right.
Ooh, look at that. That's creepy. CG though, so you know, can only get so excited for something.
This is Black Iron to transport ship Caron. You are cleared for landing.
I think it's a world premiere, so I think this is a brand new thing. The Callisto Protocol? 2022? Damn, that's a long time to wait for something you're dropping only this year, but I guess it gives you plenty of time to really look at it. Striking Distance Studios. That's not a name I've heard of that. I've not heard of that. Striking Distance.
I'm feeling some Dead Space vibes, and there's little wonder why. You know him from his work on Dead Space and Call of Duty. Here's the CEO of Striking Distance Studios, Glenn Schofield. Hey, Glenn.
Oh!
Hey, thanks, Jeff. Well, the Callisto Protocol has been in development for over a year and a half with a team of well over 100 people on it. It's a single-player, third-person, story-driven survival horror game set in the year 2320 on Jupiter's moon of Callisto. Our goal is to make the single most scariest game for PC and consoles, and we're so excited to be able to show it here tonight.
He was the director
awesome.
Of
Thank you
Dead
very much,
Space.
Glenn. We're looking forward to hearing more about that next year. All right. Announced back in July, Warhammer 40K Darktide is a four-player co-op.
Okay, well,
developers behind Warhammer
take
Vermintide
as long
2.
As you need,
well, tonight,
Striking Distance.
Check this out.
Warhammer 40K, okay, sure.
forgot what it is already. Okay. But it's a new studio that is, yeah, it's Dead Space, motherfucker. Oh, I'm sorry, it's, well, speaking of Dead Space, yeah, Dead Space is up there. But it's also not Dead Space. It's the same studio making the skin that was Left 4 Dead and Dead Space, but new teams, new games, same shit. Nothing of note. Aside from the winner of best ongoing game was fucking Moment. Not Destiny 2, not Fortnite, fucking No Man's Sky. I'm having love. There you go. That's all you needed. That's all we needed. As usual,
now it is time to recognize some other winners. In the category of best art direction, the nominees are Final Fantasy VII Remake.
Fuck you.
Ghost of Tsushima.
Fuck you. Well, yes, actually.
Ori and the Will of the Wisps.
Yes.
And The Last of Us Part 2.
Fuck you.
And the Game Award goes to Ghost of Tsushima. Congratulations to Sucker Punch.
Oh, man. I wish it was fucking Ori, but hey, Ghost deserves it too.
Hades.
Best action game. Yeah, Doom.
Alex.
Doom.
Neo 2. And Streets of Rage 4.
If not Doom, then Streets of Rage.
Hades.
Oh, is Hades really that good?
In the category of best VR, the nominees are Dreams, Half-Life Alyx, Marvel's Iron Man VR,
I guess Half-Life Alyx, because man,
and The Walking Dead: Saints and Sinners. And the game award goes to
Hades is like 20% off right now on Steam, so I might just
sports racing game. Those nominees are Dirt 5, F1 2020, FIFA 21, NBA 2K21, and Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 1 and 2. And the game award goes to Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 1 and 2. Congratulations, Tony.
Yeah. All right.
And for the most anticipated game,
original soundtrack, Super Giant
year,
Collection.
The nominees are Elden Ring.
All right.
There I said it. God of War sequel. Halo Infinite. Horizon Forbidden West. Resident Evil Village.
All right.
And The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild sequel.
Ooh. Make
and
sure
your
that
most anticipated game is Elden Ring. Congratulations to
Elden
Software.
Ring's never coming out.
All right.
Elden Ring
this
is dead.
This next game comes from the creators of Gone Home and Tacoma. The Fulbright Company and Annapurna Interactive present one part road trip, one part mystery, with two familiar voices. Check it out.
Yeah, let's use my card. It's fine. There you go. I must agree to the terms and service. Who was that studio at the start I didn't see because I'm too busy buying Hades?
My name is Tess Devine, and the world is passing me by.
I just bought Hades.
I guess as I get a little older,
I just bought Hades.
All
right. I'll buckle down. I'll play it.
They decline and go away.
Yeah, the voice sounds familiar.
That's how it was with my grandma.
Fulbright?
I loved her so much.
I think this is,
better than anyone. But looking through her old things, we found hints of something she never told us about. A man who wasn't my grandfather, a burglary ring, some sort of lost fortune. We can't ask her about these things anymore, so we have to go looking for the answers ourselves. My mom and I are out on the road, searching. I don't know what we'll find, but whatever it is, I know we'll find it together.
It's two different art styles, like full on like painting and like anime-ish styles. Open Roads, Carrie Russell and Caitlin Dever. I don't know who those are, actually. I'm sure they're well paid. I don't know.
All right, once again this year, we're excited to share some stories about people around the world who are making a positive impact on the gaming community. These are
they sound
gaming.
Like they're well paid, for sure.
Latinx
that's the best way I can describe
this
it.
Important story.
All right, so this is actually quite cool of them. They actually show off like different areas of the world that are making games and shit,
starting,
like even like in low income areas and shit like that.
Person.
I always like these sections and like see like what they're actually
it
doing.
Still
with it
still feels like I'm the odd one out.
I felt alone. I was often the only woman and the only Latino woman in the room.
I think about how hard it was for me.
Game designer of Halo
today,
Infinite.
And I don't want anyone to go through that anymore.
And welcome to Latinx in Gaming. Our content, our voices.
Latinx in Gaming is a group of people that are dedicated to supporting
other people of Latinx descent in the gaming space.
The past 3 years, we've just grown from a really small group into thousands.
This was no longer just about game developers. This is about streamers and students and journalists and marketing and fans.
Pave the way for people like
absolutely.
Me. Pave the way for people in our community.
For sure, being
you're
of Latin descent,
out there doing
I may not act like it, but I am myself.
It's a really beautiful thing.
That is
I'm
cool.
I'm trying not to cry. I was
it's not a game studio, but it's just like a group of organized people. That do like gaming and other shit too. So,
hey everyone, my name is Anna Donlin. I am the executive producer of Valorant, and I cannot believe that it has been only half a year since we launched this game. Our Valorant community has shown up in
Valorant
such a huge way, helping us take this tech shooter from an idea to a home for tens of millions of players around the world. To celebrate this, we've teamed up with the Game Awards to highlight one of the most vital pieces of our community. Honestly,
I don't
the
even
ones
remember
that got
this,
us started
but
in
sure.
the first place. Are Valorant streamers. Together
Overwatch
we ran a stanza
plus CSGO.
To name
okay.
the best emerging Valorant
no
streamer
water, I didn't
from
pay
our
attention.
Global community list. We'll announce the winner before the end of the show, and then we'll all go raid their stream together.
No.
Again, I want to thank you all for playing Valorant,
no.
and I'll leave you with just a taste of what we've all done together this year.
The potential of Valorant. I love it.
No.
Let's go, baby!
Oh, ninja's on it!
I got this.
I got, you know what you got me? I got sick for a second, actually. I saw Ninja and my fucking, my mind bursted. No thanks. You're not fucking kidding. This shit looks just like fucking Overwatch. Oh yeah, I didn't mention this in my top 10, but that fuck that final boss section. Not because it's hard or anything, but really the final boss is not even the boss itself, it's fighting more enemies. Yeah, that's the best part of the game, but I also like how variety and how well variety and different the bosses were previously to that. But then you get to the final boss and it's nothing but shoot the armor off and then kill everything around it. I really didn't like it. The boss right before that was super fun. Because that one you had to like use your super punch and you had to like start building for that and then like literally up in the sky and punch the shit out of her. Like that, great. All the other shit.
And they are so cute.
What the fuck? What? Why whoopers? What whooper?
What
whooper?
Mudslap.
What are they doing here?
Numbers of whooper will appear in the wild. We've also been told you could encounter a shiny Wooper if you're lucky, so open up Pokemon Go and catch some Wooper while you watch this evening.
I thought Pokemon Go died after, like, its Chicago event. These look like PS2 models.
Get up, detective. One last time.
Oh, it is dead? I thought my brother was playing it, actually. Not my older brother, my little brother.
So, get out there, solve a murder with a unique skill system at your disposal. Carve your own path.
Sims, but detective and
open world.
Oh shit! Oh my god, he just fucked that kid up. I might get this game. Oh my god.
Meet and get to know more of the locals.
He looks like Kane from Kane and Lynch.
Sure thing, champ. Lead the way.
Art style is so odd. It's like muddy, but
it's okay.
With full
but different.
Voice acting for
it's
every
so weird.
Single one of the city's beautiful people.
Yes. I'm going to unplug the microphone, okay?
Cool and all. I mean, that's a good reason why it would die, right? But you know,
boy, you can handle it.
You gotta leave the house sometime to catch that sand slash. Yeah, I don't know. I'm not really feeling this.
Enjoy the definitive edition of this hit RPG. Disco Elysium. The final cut. A free upgrade for all players.
Yeah, I don't know about that, actually. The fact that it's on Stadia 2, like, yeah, you're giving me Stadia vibes right now. I don't want that. Yeah, the definitive edition that comes with a embryo. I don't know. I'm not gonna. I'm just saying I'm not interested. Maybe it is a good game. I don't know.
Welcome back to the Game Awards. That's so exciting. Disco Elysium News. You may remember last year they were, I think, they won the most awards out of any game last year at the Game Awards. So awesome.
That's
news.
Neat.
All right. Well, now we're going to talk about BioWare's Dragon Age franchise. It is known for its story and its characters. And right now, the team at BioWare wanted to give you a little sneak preview of what to expect in the next game and where it will take us. Enjoy.
I mean, does anyone really care about BioWare now? Especially since it fucked up about all the shits about Mass Effect
and would-be gods
and Dragon Age.
Seen friends lose life and limb, but there's always someone bent on breaking.
I tried liking Dragon Age Origins, which is the one that was on PS4. I really tried, but I really couldn't get into it.
It's time for a new hero.
Are they just gonna try and be Monster Hunter?
No ancient prophecy.
I wonder if that's like their angle.
The kind of person they'll never see coming. We've got your back. I've got your back. Demons, dragons, darkspawn.
I'm not really that stoked about what this looks like right now. I mean, obviously CG, like I said before, but I don't know. It just hasn't.
This is your story.
It's just Dragon Age? Are you just a reboot? What is this? It's just Dragon Age. Yeah, just like Doom. Great.
All right, we're back, and I'm trapped in our set now. I don't know what's going on. All right, well, next we'll have a look at an exciting new tactical squad-based roguelite game set in the Endless
tactical
Universe.
Tactical-based
roguelike.
Here is another
new game announcement.
Tactical-based roguelike. Is it fucking XCOM? No, Sega. Sega. Amplitude? These guys got fucked. Is it just those three? Yeah, I don't think that there's been like a endless dungeon. Huh. Switch as well? It's interesting. I mean, the fact that it's like with more than one person too. Like, I actually kind of like
that. The new open-world action-adventure game from Pearl Abyss. This next-gen game offers in-depth, story-driven single-player content in an MMO setting. What you're about to see includes actual gameplay footage. This is the beautiful and merciless world of Crimson Desert.
That's a good name. Crimson Desert. Yeah, never believe these actual in-game footages because, yeah, sure, actual in-game footage now or pre-rendered in the game. I actually trust pre-rendered in the game more than actual in-game footage because that shit, yeah. Look at Kingdom Hearts. That shit was fucking actual in-game footage before that whole entire way that they made it got canned and then they did Unreal. So, yeah. MMO too, by the way. Single-player MMO. What? Like, I'm only just putting that piece together. Like, wait a minute. It's a lot of establishing shots. A lot of establishing shots. There you go. Oh, real hard cut. All right. It does look pretty, like, pretty nice. Looks like actually like Assassin's Creed. Oh, okay. Well, it's not Assassin's Creed. I just saw fucking like orc shit. So it's not that, obviously. It's a really weird how, really weird way how they're presenting this game as like the trailer. It's a lot of like just build up for, I'm sure, some sort of payoff. Facial captures are nice, I guess. Doesn't look that bad. It looks like it is a PS4 game. Nothing really screams next gen, though. So, I mean, that's... I feel like this generation is the, like, let's make sure that the game still looks good while running at a solid 60. And not really losing any, like, resolution. I feel like that's really the next gen improvement. Like, finally, we can stop talking about graphics and we can actually talk about performance. That's interesting, I guess. There we go. Finally, like, what the game looks like. Ooh. Oh, wow. Okay. This actually looking kind of nice. Like, at least his movement. Yeah, that's actually looking kind of fire. There's their health bars. The UI is kind of trash, because look, it's just two white meters and a red meter. But hey, I'm sure it's a... sure, it's in development still. No, nothing really set in stone. Still, it actually, nah, it kind of won me over, at least for the gameplay part. This looks kind of cool. Oh, did he just fucking do a fucking swinging net breaker? Yo, he just, okay. The fact that he just yeeted a grown-ass man, yeah, all right. I'm a performance sick. Nice. I mean, technically I perform, but not well. Whoa, cool. Like making your own platforms? Yeah, this trailer is not really made that well. Yeah, all right. Okay. Giving me, not Dragon Age. Not Dragon's Crown. Why am I forgetting the name of it? The Capcom game. Shit. I'm drawing a blank. I can't remember. Whatever. Dragon's Dogma. There it is. It was giving me Dragon's Dogma vibes. Seems like it's destructible environment, so that just might be cutscene. When's Bloodborne 2? No. Dude, stop. Dude, fucking stop. It hurts my soul, the fact that they're going like all over the place with this fucking Elden Ring and we don't even know anything about it. That means that to me that if they are working on a Bloodborne, I would hope that they're making like a remaster of it, so that way it adds the DLC, gets a solid 60 frames per second with better performance, new weapons and shit. But I don't think that we're gonna get a Bloodborne 2 until maybe like after like mid-cycle of PS5 shit. I really hope so. Like, I really hope that is a thing, because fucking Bloodborne is magic to me. Winter of next year, okay. Yeah, it definitely has a lot of, has a lot of way to go, for sure. Pearl Abyss. Let me see who that is.
I love having new IP and new teams on stage. South Korea, that's fantastic. Crimson Desert.
South All right, Korea.
Now to present our next award. Yeah, he joined me in Fortnite earlier this year. The
yeah,
star
that's
of Tenet,
pretty new.
John
yeah.
David Washington. Hey, John.
Hey,
I'll be on the lookout for that
awards.
For sure.
As you know, in Christopher Nolan's latest film, Tenet, I play the character called the protagonist.
very.
I never seen this movie, so I don't know that.
I thought that was a cool name for.
Nobody really saw it because nobody can go to movie theaters, bro.
We're all the protagonists, helping to tell the story of the game with our choices. Great narratives in games are the perfect balance of that feeling of being in control, but also being guided by brilliant storytellers. And so, these are the nominees for Best Narrative.
All right, narrative. I forgot which one I voted. I don't know what Hades is about, so I can't vote for this. No. Dude, this shit's gonna win. This shit is gonna win. Oh.
I will sacrifice everything.
Yeah, the story wasn't all that, honestly. I didn't mention that before. Oh, this better not win. Well, at least for me. Maybe for... Yeah, 13 Sentinels! This is gonna be on my pool. You guys have no fucking clue. You guys have no fucking clue. 13
and
Sentinels.
The game award goes to... The Last of Us Part 2.
I'm going to the bathroom.
Oh my god. Okay. This is the first award acceptance speech I've ever done, so I wrote it down so I wouldn't mess it up. But okay, here we go. This is amazing. First off, it's such an honor to be nominated with so many incredible games that came out this year. So truly, truly. Of course, I've got to thank my co-writer and the director of The Last of Us Part 2, Neil Druckmann, who was courageous enough to tell such a ballsy story. And a big shout out and thanks also to our other writers, Josh Scher and Ryan James, and of course the entire Naughty Dog studio. This game is what it is because of the collaborative nature at that studio and their love of narrative. And of course, thank you mostly and always to the fans. These characters meant so much to us and we're really touched that they resonated with you as well. So thank you.
Right now, we've got a very special guest who has some exciting news for all you virtual chefs out there. Joining us all the way from his kitchen, it's the Swedish chef. Chef, are you there?
Furniture, picking the number one. Oh, the mummy, hundi, puppy, funny, furniture to be today. And for the super duper hot spoon. Oh, the spoon. And for the noodle. And this for the whisk. Oh, it's for the chickies. The chicky is for the...
Chef, I'm so sorry to cut you off. And you're looking sharp in that tux, by the way. My Swedish, it's a little rusty, but I think there's been a little bit of confusion, honestly.
No. It's for the win. Thank you for the shooty Cuban de Froggy. And for taking all the shooty Froggy and from the sheen de Froggy.
No, Chef, I'm so sorry, but you didn't actually win a game award. That trophy you've got, honestly, it kind of looks like leftovers. Anyways, you're supposed to be sharing an announcement here about a co-op game.
The Coop?
No, a co-op game, like a fun, cool new game with a playable character named Swedish Chef.
Me? For the Play-Doh?
Yes, that is why you're here, for a world premiere. Let's take a look.
Okie dokie.
And there you have it. What do you think, Chef?
Furniture. It's for the picking the number one, for the mummy, and for the poopy. If only the pizza day.
Oh my. All right. Well, congratulations to the Swedish Chef. This time it's real. Swedish Chef is playable in Overcooked All You Can Eat on PS5 and Xbox Series X, and he's available right now. Coming up, Gal Gadot is presenting our Games for Impact Award, and we'll head to Abbey Road Studios to celebrate Mario's 35th anniversary with the world famous London Philharmonic Orchestra. But right now, let's hear from Dr. Lupo about a new initiative at the Game Awards, Future Class.
Hey y'all, I'm Dr. Lupo, and tonight I'm honored to partner with Gillette to introduce the Game Awards Future Class, a group of thinkers, dreamers, and pioneers who represent the bright, bold, and inclusive future for video games.
And then I forget why people hate the Game Awards.
Games have really changed my life, to be honest with you.
All right.
My name is Royce Payne. I'm a senior computer science major at Morehouse College, and I'm currently playing on the Morehouse Maroon Tiger gaming team.
We see other big colleges are able to have these gaming teams and they're winning scholarships. For us not to have it, we're like,
and then they bring on another one of these, so that's fine. That's fine with me.
We're just a collection of HBCUs who have different passionate gamers who want to compete against one another. We played against some good competition so far. Just being able to break into that space and open the door.
Yeah, you can talk about how, yeah, change your life. Yeah, it gets small.
Huge for me.
No, I'm just kidding.
Oh, hi,
I'm just saying he sniped him. Come on. Can you let me
my mansion.
Try it at least.
As someone with a chronic respiratory illness, I've had to find some unique ways to deal with the 2020 situation. Like,
I don't know.
I go for a swim in my Olympic size.
Look,
that's not Olympic. The,
she looks
the
like
Olympic
a fucking
one is
doll.
Indoors. So. But I know that there are some people out there watching
oh,
this.
Oh, she's from, she was from IGN and then
down.
Went over to Funhouse.
The high levels of nicotine
was.
That you can be inhaling
so,
can actually worsen
yeah,
your
anxiety. Yeah, I don't remember her name, but she was from like IGN and then went over
the
to
mental
Funhouse.
Health battle
yeah.
That is
that was basically by the time I
this
stopped watching.
Year. Not that I would know because
you got like three, you know. Five man.
But that
in
doesn't mean
pod,
I'm not trying to look out
and
for you.
One of them is more.
For those
than
of you
five.
Who are looking to quit vaping, which I hope
I mean,
you are, this is quitting is a free text-based
don't,
program.
Don't play the new Call of Duty. Just keep playing Modern Warfare.
Text game awards to 88709.
It seems like the multiplayer is ass for the new one, so I don't know. Who knows? I'll just go back to fucking Modern Warfare 2 instead. Oh shit, I gotta mute this whole thing or else I'm gonna get DMCA'd. Shit. Nintendo's gonna spam my account. Oh yeah, and they're also gonna take away your Joy-Con boys, Joy-Cons. And they're also going to take away money for the suicide prevention for teens.
I want that Mario music and, back. That was fun. All right, back in 1997.
Yeah. They're also going
to
stop Melee. They're also
going to
stop Splatoon 2
franchise.
Because
tonight,
you like
they're
Melee.
They're teaming up again for this epic game store world
they also don't know what internet is.
Right
and,
now.
Yeah. There you go. Oh, Warframe? Hey, there you go. Cool, cool. Wait, what? Run by me what the question is. Exactly. Do you mean the Joy-Con boys one? Do you mean the Splatoon one? Do you mean the free Melee one? Do you mean which specific part? Because there's a lot that happened in the past few weeks that, Yeah, this doesn't look like the original Warframe that I'm used to.
Enemy casualties are enormous. Your progress,
Dracoon. Yeah, I'm.
In line with projections.
I don't know. I just haven't been on top with Warframe at all, so it's probably the better Halo right now. I don't know.
Welcome back to the Game Awards. Earlier, I asked you to head over to Instagram to post our Game of the Year AR effects to your reel.
They're just skins?
Let's check
oh, wow.
out a couple of your creations.
Yeah, they're still at least making content, so.
Keep posting on Instagram, and I'll share some more in just a bit. Now back to your host, Jeff Keighley.
Thank you very much.
Did
Sid.
You just
last
see
month,
that Naruto fan just do the shit? Oh wait. What's his name? The guy
on
from
16th,
the guy that plays guy in
off.
Street Fighter 4. Bushido. Bushido something.
A massive update.
Shit. What's his name? The one that got 5-0'd by like Teddy guy.
First look at the gameplay.
What the fuck is that called? What's the? It's gonna. I gotta find it. USF 4. First to 10, Bushido.
He has some pieces of the
is it Bushido Black? No, no.
A piece himself. He won't live long
shit.
To work that out.
Can't remember. Was it a first to 5? Maybe it was a first to 5, not a first to 10.
Vengeance.
Fuck, I can't find it. Hold on. I gotta find this. WNF. I know it was at Wednesday Night Fights. Rico Suave. Fuck, I can't remember.
Coming.
We are in control.
He's trying to bait you, Abby.
No shit.
Whatever. I can't find it. I can't remember.
I won't show him.
What are we watching? I saw shooting first person. And I just looked away. Oh, it's Black Ops. It's Black Ops. Okay. At least I think.
Kill the rest. Adler is mine.
I don't. What? Who, are we supposed to know who that is?
We knew this year that the Game Awards Orchestra wasn't going to be easy to pull off, but we had to try. I know how much we all love video game music. Well, I'm really proud of what we've got for
a Black
you
Ops
right
suit.
Now.
Map is back? Well, hey, that gives them nine
year,
multiplayer maps. Yep.
Nice. Nintendo's
nice that Black Ops now has still less than every other Call of Duty map
here
ever.
To perform a medley
fucking
of Mario songs from the legendary
you know what?
Let me
look it up. Let me look it up.
This is the world-class London Philharmonic Orchestra led by conductor Lauren Balfe. Enjoy.
Let's see. Call of Duty 4 Modern Warfare maps. Let's see how many there are in the original Call of Duty. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Call of Duty Modern Warfare, like Call of Duty 4 Modern Warfare, the original, had 20 maps. And Black Ops 3 has like 9. So like, hey, quality, right? As long as it's good zombies, right? Non-DLC, correct. Non-DLC, because those also counted for like those 1v1 maps that were really small. Like Shipment and shit, there was like maybe 5 of those. So yeah, still, it's a fucking lot. And then Modern Warfare 2 like had like maybe like 14 and shit. With the third oh my god. Do you imagine they brought back fucking third-person Call of Duty like how they did in Modern Warfare 2? I would fucking play the shit out of that. At least give me modes for that. That would be fucking rad as shit. I loved it. I never played it all the time, but like just what I wanted to. It was like, yeah, it's fucking cool. Yeah, by the way, yeah, the London Philharmonic, yeah, obviously. Play Mario World, those songs, you cowards.
That kind of makes everything better, doesn't it? Wow. Thank you to Lauren and the London Philharmonic. They'll be back again later in the show. And
oh, yo, I was about to fucking say, they did not just get
lots
the London Philharmonic for 2 minutes.
Right now. I know it might feel
I was about to fucking lose
to
it.
These games, but
Zombie Arcade and Cold War is third person. Oh, that's
not
like a top-down,
to
but yeah, that's I know what you mean.
To travel the world,
third-person shooting versus like
well,
the top-down. Still, like, I get what you mean.
Where you can do all of that as you explore.
I guess that's the closest thing that they ever had to that mode.
In a strange, beautiful world. This game is just stunning, and it's coming to PlayStation 5. Check it out.
Persona 3 Remake. Bugsnax 2. Scavenger Studio, okay.
Our grandparents lived for 1,000 years.
Looks really
and
fucking
our parents
cool. Like
had
the art direction.
Themselves. But us, we have one season.
Season? Is this like a walk and talk type thing? Just like a journey-esque without really gameplay? I'm fine with experiences like that. This looks nice. This actually looks really nice. I'll have to see a little bit more than that, though. But if that's really the game, though, then, like, that's probably, like, just, like, a $15 thing.
Beautiful.
Like, that's Journey season. And all right. Flower well, and all those games.
Another
yeah.
Another Game Award. She's the that's star fine. Of the upcoming film Wonder Woman 1984. Here is Gal Gadot. Hey, Gal.
Thanks, Jeff.
Oh, she hates Marcus Brony, actually. But
lots
then unblocked him after
games
that.
Are fun to play, yeah, but each
Marcus Brony is actually one of a YouTuber I watch that does a lot of tech stuff. He's very informative. I love his reviews.
That can be historical, political,
he actually was on the Joe Rogan podcast when he said this.
The games for
he saw that Gal Gadot had tweeted something out on Twitter saying like how the Apple something or like whatever phone that she was texting from is a fantastic phone or whatever, and I love it, like just to do promotion for it. But it turns out that like she did it from like the rival phone like company, like it was like supposed to be like a Samsung or some shit, and then she tweeted it from an Apple, and then Marcus Brony retweeted and said, "This you?" Like with, you know, nothing Apple's name on it, memories. Even though you're promoting they something really else, and then she blocked that. Him on. I think she later unblocked him or something.
We knew we.
I don't know any of these games, so.
No matter the cost.
Games for Impact.
And the Game Award goes to.
Why are you?
Tell me why.
Tell me why. Dude, I might get DMC for that. Shit, I can't like music.
The entire team from both Don't Nod Entertainment and Xbox Publishing, thank you so much for this award.
Yeah, I don't know who that is, and I also don't know the game, but congrats, I guess.
Tyler and Allison and their journey. I'd like to express
I thought those guys were
new games. For all of tonight's especially
no, I don't know what they are.
Tell stories about
I'm unfortunately, I'm not familiar with any of those. So.
With sincerity and heart.
Whoops.
Here's to a future where even more marginalized people can see themselves and their experiences truly reflected in the games they play. Thank
yeah, you
so,
could tell
so
that she's talking from like the webcam monitor.
Congratulations.
And, the
everyone's joining us live.
Microphone
the tech is
shit.
Working. This is amazing, and it's so cool to see everyone. All right, well, right now we've got another brand new game announcement for you. Check this out. Unexpected.
Unexpected, huh? Persona 3 Remake. Far Cry... Oh no! Oh no! Oh man, what is Vin Diesel doing? Are you kidding me? What? Oh, I fucking can't. I can't. I can't right now. Fast and the Furious. Dinosaur. I don't even have a bit for this. I can't even come up with anything. This looks like shit, by the way. Unobjectively. This looks horrible. But, alright. Vin Diesel just doing grunting all day. Alright, maybe I'll bite. Maybe I'll bite. Why would you stop running, too? Nice.
Thank you.
Oh, they really gave Vin Diesel a whole fucking shit ton of money. This music is putting me to sleep, actually. Oh my god. I wish I had more to say. I wish I did, but I legit have nothing. Other than Horizon Zero Dawn 3. The fuck is iPads doing here? He looks so bad. Oh my god.
Lights out, old friend.
I'm tired. Arc 2? And just to give him one more shot.
Yeah, that's right. Arc 2 starring Vin Diesel. And the team at Studio Wildcard has one more announcement for all Arc fans. Check this out.
Can you feel it? The balance of nature has been altered. There is someone out there who may change our fate, who could lead us out of the darkness. And yet I wonder, hunted and alone on this strange new world.
Oh, I can't look at fucking Twitter. I can't look at anything. I know, I can't look at anything. Fuck. Let me start from the beginning. Oh, I don't really care. It's fine. Oh, I missed it? Oh, damn. Oh, okay, all right, cool. So apparently I missed, we missed the beginning of the, you know, thing here for the Game Awards, and the band that did the Persona music was supposed to perform. We missed that, too. So they played the battle theme for Strikers, so I'll watch that on my own time. That's fine.
Good boy.
And we missed some awards, and of course the Smash reveal. So, basically just hope for that. All I wanted to do is just look up in YouTube, whatever it is, just find the video and just start it from the beginning, full screen it. Yeah, no, the Smash reveal. That's all I care about. All right, that's fine. You have to do it on this computer though. So like. Did they show Strikers? Did they show Strikers the game, or just they did the performance? They just did a performance, which you can see the gameplay all you want because they have the English trailer and they have, of course, the Japanese game, of course, out. So you can always look at that.
Especially when we were all in lockdown. This holiday season, Fall Guys is back with a Winter Wonderland for Season 3. Here's your first look.
I'm just waiting for that Among Us, bro. Let's go. They're supposed to show a new Among Us match. Yeah, they're showing it here.
It's the most wonderful time of the year. With the kids jingle belling and everyone telling you be of good cheer. It's the most wonderful time of the year.
Did I ever play Fall Guys? It was at PAX, the most recent PAX we were just at. I wanted to play it, but I didn't get a chance to. Brett's been playing it, like, he played it a shit ton. He got, like, first place a whole lot. But I feel like getting into it now with the seasons out, with more maps, I feel like now's a good time for me to, like, to at least, you know, give it a shot. Because I kind of like got bored of seeing the exact same things over and over again. So I don't really care about the costumes. It's more like I just want to see like what new map they can have. Yeah, for sure. I know it is fun. It's just more of like, should I know like to play it or not? You know, with all these maps and shit. And they're an indie developer too, so you know. They have a lot of costumes, I'll give them that. Are any of them pay to win? Or pay to, unlock? Yeah.
The Game Festival is going on right now, and you can stream all the Game Festival demos using any device you own with GeForce Now. You can check that out.
Oh, you get crowned by
the Game Festival. Lots of amazing games you can play all
weekend
long.
But can you get anything by?
All right, coming up next,
Tom
Holland, Nolan North, and the award for best multiplayer. More awards and announcements, and later we've got Reggie, Keanu Reeves, plus Eddie Vedder from Pearl Jam. Playing his song from The Last of Us Part 2, but right now,
I mean, dressing
Elite
a bean
Dangerous
is easy.
Is
you know what?
MMO
fair enough.
From Frontier. Players have been
but you could also
the
just. Well, then again, the Among
decades.
Us guys are also
Here
beans
is the
too.
Gameplay reveal of Odyssey
I don't know.
Let you explore on foot.
Technically, Fallout. Wow. Among Us came out first, so. Fucking Fallout. Why'd I say that?
Ground control to Major Tom. Ground control to Major Tom.
It says in game footage.
Take your protein pills and put your helmet on. This
Aster's
is
hope.
Major Tom to ground control.
Yeah, this is not No Man's Sky. Yo, Knight, what was... Do you remember what the Left 4 Dead game was called? Born for Blood or something. They actually have game footage of that. And the alpha's coming out on the 17th. Yeah, look it up for sure. Back for Blood, yes. Back for Blood.
We all need a way of coping.
Yo, why does New Zealand always look so fucking beautiful?
Games is... an incredible way of doing that. I'm Jennifer Hazel. I'm a medical doctor. When I started specializing in mental health specifically, something clicked. I realized that all my life I'd been using video games as a way of nurturing my own well-being.
Using a PS4 controller on PC?
Hi.
I don't know.
And so I established Checkpoint to bring mental health resources to the gaming community.
You know what's better?
What is mental health?
The PS5
we use
controller.
Games as a medium to raise awareness and to reduce stigma and to provide real tangible resources to people who are struggling.
That's
that
a, she actually put
Senua
on her
life.
Page. Yeah, that fucking makes
Above
sense.
Above all else, I want people to know that it's okay to be struggling at the moment. There
yeah,
are resources
again.
Out there.
Claps. Claps for this.
It will help and it will get better.
This is always a nice thing, for sure.
Welcome to Enoch. A
I'll show you my Enoch.
Madness and misery. If you don't want to end up as worm food, what worked for you in the old world won't work here.
Mantra.
Running and hiding are simply not viable.
It looks like
options.
Mass Effect.
Here, if you plan
like
on
a new Mass Effect,
you need
but
to shift your mind into a higher gear. Let me walk you through the mantras of
mantras
survival.
Of survival? Could I have your attention, Square Enix. Please. People can fly. I
First,
don't know who they are.
Cover is for cowards. Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, fuck you, Gears of War.
Nobody stopped it. But you're a biological sledgehammer. Act like one. Chuck yourself into the fray.
This is giving me Lawbreaker
Two,
vibes.
Your powers are on tap.
Like the way how they're presenting the game, it's like, oh, you're a bitch
your
if you don't fly our game.
To be unleashed. Don't keep them waiting.
That didn't really work out for Lawbreaker, though, so I don't know.
You've got to kill to heal. There's no use licking your wounds. Want your health back? Get out there and take it. Violence breeds vitality. And finally, a guiding philosophy to end. You have to think aggressively.
wrestling.
Okay. So far, these are all, like, it's cinematic feeling for gameplay. Watch, yeah, you gotta actually, like, see gameplay for this, but... I've seen billions of trailers like this, though, so... Outriders. All right. PS5, Steam, everything. All right.
The Tinder could be a threat.
Oh, the new Star Fox. Yeah. Twice
before you hand it to them.
What? All right. I did not think I was looking at a side scroller. I think. Odd, but sure. The designs are pretty cool. Fist? All right, now I'm not interested. That's really the name? No, I'm good.
I've got you under my skin. I've got
it's AMD
you
and Xbox.
Deep in the heart of me. Dug deep in my heart that you're really a part of me.
Were they adding a new Series X thing? The processing power for the Series X. Oh, it's literally just an all right, just an ad for AMD. All right, that was a waste, I guess. Just a
hey, what's up, guys? It's Tom Holland here. I am in Atlanta on the set of the next Spider-Man film, but I am honored to be a part of the Game Awards tonight. You know that for the past few years, I've been working on the Uncharted movie, which did involve some extensive research playing the games. I'm honored to be playing Nathan Drake. What I can assure you is that we really want to honor Naughty Dog's amazing games. So this film tells you how Nathan Drake became the character we all know and love. It is now my honor to introduce my good friend, Nathan Drake. Please welcome Mr. Nolan.
Yeah! Yes! Oh, he's there! Sick!
Thank you, Tom. I could not be more proud of you. You know, someday when someone searches for Nathan Drake on IMDb, and you are the first result, I will only be remarkably bitter. You know, video games allow us to connect.
I thought they
friends,
were gonna like
family,
show off like the trailer. I was actually getting super excited for a second.
Experiences beyond
damn it
the confines of our
oh well
homes.
At least it's good seeing Nolan
to
North.
New worlds with our buddies on the couch next to us. Of all the years I've been grateful for multiplayer games, they've never been more important to us than they were in this historically crappy, rotten, no good, cursed year. These are the nominees for best multiplayer.
It's Among Us.
Best
I'm shooting for Among Us.
By Instagram.
If you don't fucking vote for Among Us, you are mad sus. Multiplayer? Warzone? I Fall Guys definitely could win. I can see Fall Guys winning. I don't know about this Valorant. I don't see anybody playing. Call of Duty, most likely. Among
and
Us
the game
or
award goes to
Fall Guys.
Among Us.
This is it's so easy. It's so easy. Vote him out.
Oh,
vote him
so
out.
Much. Oh my god. I can do this. All right. Thank you, Game Awards and everyone.
Inner Sloth. You know what? I haven't looked up
the
studio at all.
It's an honor to have won best multiplayer category. Our goal with Among Us.
I gotta like see more of their stuff.
Experience. Amongst friends. 2 years ago, Among Us started with
Dig to China.
Google Mobile.
Oh.
And then,
oh.
PC, and the rest is
oh
history. Now more
that's
than ever,
them.
Finding ways to connect with friends is
oh,
increasing
shit.
And we're so happy many of you chose
that's
Among
cool
Us to play
okay
with friends and family.
I got it. Got it.
Big thank you to Robot Teddy, Dual Studio, and our other partners for helping us navigate all the excitement. Thank you to our moderators and the fans who have been on this journey with us for the past 2 years. And big thank you to our friends and family. You've helped us test and been incredibly supportive through it all. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
That was so incredibly
you've been
sweet.
Using Instagram's Shout out to Among Us. To add
oh man,
snazzy trophy
that's awesome.
To your reel. Let's check out a couple of those.
Fucking deserved. Among Us is so
You're all
perfect.
Winners in my book.
Get out of
Keep
here.
Keep making those
guy,
trophies,
whatever.
And I'll be back with more later. Now back to Jeff.
No, please stop. You, right, no more of you,
much,
please.
Sydney.
No more of this Instagram shit.
Later, Among Us, the new map reveal. All right, now we've got
yeah,
another
still,
brand new
for,
game announcement.
They should have just done it
fun.
Here, but whatever.
It's one of your favorite supernatural horror franchises, and it looks like a bloody good time. Check it out.
Supernatural horror franchise. Saber Interactive. What? Boston.
I had a real life once. I had a wonderful girlfriend, Linda. Together we drove to a small cabin in the mountains. Necronomicon Ex Mortis, the Book of the Dead. It seems an archaeologist had come to this remote place to translate and study.
What the hell, Knight? What?
It was never meant for the world of the living. The book awoke something dark in the woods.
Now I'm super confused.
It took Linda. And then it came.
Wow. All right.
For me.
Wow. Okay. Well, this looks and feels just like the Friday the 13th game. No thanks.
There you go. Evil Dead the game. Next up, a classic game franchise is being remade. Take a look at this announcement.
Persona 3 Remake. I'll keep saying it until it comes to life. Oh, what? No. Oh! Hey! Wow! Oh, look at that! Oh, you know what? You know what? You know what? I'm with it. I'm with it. This is a hard-ass video game series, but you know what? This is goofy, and wow, I never would have in a million years would think a remake for Ghouls and Ghosts. Or, Ghosts and Goblins, whatever. I always get the two mixed up. Whatever. Wow. Is it just super Ghosts and Goblins? Oh, you could, okay. Little Capcom arcade thing, that's cool. But what was on it? Was it all of those that was shown?
We love ourselves some Capcom arcade classics.
I don't know which ones they were.
Some more winners. In the category of best independent game, the nominees are Carrion, Fall Guys Ultimate Knockout, Hades, Spelunky 2, and Spiritfire.
Hades
and the
game
award goes to
Hades.
Hades.
Yeah.
Congratulations, Supergiant.
Fucking hell. Supergiant is so good, but I really need. All right.
Ghost of
Tsushima, Design.
Half-Life Alyx, Resident Evil 3, and The Last of Us Part 2. And our winner is The Last of Us Part 2. Congratulations, Naughty Dog.
I guess. I don't know.
For best role-playing game, the nominees this year are Final Fantasy VII Remake,
sure.
Genshin Impact, Persona 5 Royal.
Oh, I forgot. Man nope,
3,
nope. P5,
Yakuza
P5.
Like a
don't
Dragon.
Be idiots.
And the game award goes to Final Fantasy VII
sure.
Remake. All right,
that's fine.
Square.
I'll meet you in the middle,
the
Square. I'll meet you in the middle.
Simulation or strategy game. Those nominees are Crusader Kings 3, Desperados 3, Gears Tactics, Microsoft Flight Simulator, and XCOM: Chimera Squad.
Okay,
and the winner is
tactics.
Microsoft Flight Simulator.
Fucking hell.
Congratulations.
Fucking hell. I don't even know what that
and
even
fan
looks
category,
like.
Category Player's Voice, you voted tournament style to pick your favorite games. The final five nominees were Doom Eternal,
mm-hmm.
Ghost of Tsushima, Hades,
uh-huh.
Marvel's Spider-Man, Miles Morales, and The Last of Us Part 2.
Hades.
And the winner, as you may know, we announced it online. Congratulations to Sucker Punch.
Oh, all right. That's fine.
Now
people really like Ghost, huh?
You. This is for best fighting game. And here to help us out from Netflix's Cobra Kai, two great rivals from film history.
Wait,
Ralph
what
Macchio
was the fighting game? Oh,
Okamoto.
It was One Punch Man that's on here.
Hey,
I forgot.
What's up, Game
I forgot
Wars?
One Punch Man
Game
is on the
Wars,
list this year.
What's up?
Oh, and by the way, fucking.
No, how would I? I mean,
why is Ralph Macchio
not
here?
You.
Because he fights. Okay, because sure.
I'm not in a game.
Oh, come on. You were in a game, Karate Kid, for Nintendo 1987, and your karate was weak.
All right, Yuji, listen, whatever, okay? Why don't we just read off the list of
nominees? Yeah, okay, you could tell that this is not really a live bit. Game. This was Blue, recorded multiple times. Those cuts are really obvious.
Street Fighter 5, Champion Edition.
One Punch Man.
Yeah, I want One Punch. I want One Punch Man to win.
And here we go. The Game Award goes to... Sorry, this thing is stuck. Somebody glue this thing?
I got you, Macho. And the winner is Mortal Kombat 11 Ultimate. Sure.
Man, I wanted One Punch to win for... Oh, I wanted that to win so bad.
All right,
oh, man.
Congratulations to Mortal Kombat, and thanks
for...
Oh, well,
whatever.
PG.
Obviously,
it's
MK. One
of the things
MK.
I have really been missing this year
if
is...
Street Fighter 5
won,
I would have thrown everything
on
my fucking desk,
games of the year
including
to help fill
the PS5.
That void a little. It just won best
I would have yeeted this
strategy
shit.
Game, Microsoft Flight Simulator. And next year, it's coming to Xbox. Here's what that's going to look like. It's an airborne view of our wonderful world.
Sure. Hey, anything to fill time. Experience the entire planet. Sure. I would have just immediately turned left into the...
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them blue.
Oh, I'm gonna get DMC'd. Oh, man. You're not allowed to like music.
What a wonderful...
That's all right. I'm willing to whisk it. To whisk it? I'm willing to whisk it?
I think to myself, what a wonderful...
Sure, whatever. Xbox need games, so let's give them more PC games.
All right, Microsoft Flight Simulator looks amazing coming next summer to Xbox.
Does it look amazing?
And now it's time to take a look at another game coming to PlayStation 5. Check it out.
Persona. All right, that's enough. Ooh, okay, so this is like straight up like first party. Neato.
My end.
Oh, is this that at the beginning? Is this that one that they announced at the...
I will go there now.
I think it is. How
I
smart.
Crash. Every time.
Yeah, this is that game. Yeah.
Cycle, I'm
the one that had no gameplay and now it has gameplay. I mean, no. Who's making this? Shooting Dark Souls, I guess? I really don't... Oh, Returnal. That's right. That's the name. PlayStation. Oh, no developer logo.
All right, we will be back in just a moment with a legend, Reggie. He's going to join us. We've also got a new look at a game.
Yeah,
the
head of GameStop himself.
One of the craziest, most unscripted moments in Game Awards history, Joseph Ferris. Plus, Eddie Vedder.
Oh, Joseph Ferris. He's the one that did
and later,
Brothers and No Way Out.
From Europe to present Content Creator of the Year, presented by Adobe.
Yo, what's going on, Honduran?
Coming up here on the Game Awards. We will see you right
there
after.
There was some neat stuff that came out so far, and I didn't see the beginning of it, so the Smash reveal or whatever it was, I have no idea. So if anyone's seen it, yeah, I'm going to watch it at the end, but yeah. That's the only thing that I'm not sure of what it was. But so far, there was quite a few nice surprises, including the new Left 4 Dead, Back 4 Blood, or whatever it's called, and the return of the Dead Space guys, too, working on whatever they're working on. There's some neat shit, so. This, I don't know what this is. She looks like... Oh, free-to-play shit. All right, well... Thanks for wasting the time. Hey, what you got? Is this just that new game that was already out for like 2 months, 3 months already? Yeah, it's the same one. Yeah. Unless it's like new content. I should play the original. Wait, I thought that was already out. All right, well, enjoy your weeaboo. Yeah, Knight's a PC boy now, so he's gonna get on that Parsec pretty soon. All right, how much hundreds of dollars do you need to spend on your next waifu? The game, like, I won't lie, for a free-to-play game, like, this, like, looks spectacular, for sure. There is that one, like, waifu girl or whatever that basically, like, has judgment cuts and, like, is, like, basically is Virgil, so that would probably be my main.
Hi,
wait,
I'm
it's not on PC? I thought it was, I thought it was PC, mobile, and
games.
PS4.
This is Abby versus Ellie from The Last of Us Part 2.
I am Team Ellie. Ellie is probably one of the greatest game characters of all time.
Yeah, and Abby can beat her up, so that makes Abby better.
Finally
Abby
became a
day.
Man. That's what happens you need to be, like, to get
a nap and some food in her. She
man,
that,
oh,
with the small car.
Apparently all those guys at Geek Squad all are have been men before I was.
Abby could be a good singer, you don't know.
Yeah, you can tell she's not a good singer. Point collectors don't make good singers.
Fair enough.
Please stop doing your beat, or your bit. Stop it.
Honey,
it is on PC. Okay.
Is it you?
I thought it was just mobile, because it said mobile. I didn't see Steam or anything, or Microsoft. Maybe it was there. I just didn't actually see it.
How far are you from the border? Be careful with the people that give you a ride. And don't travel with someone you don't know. We love you, honey.
This is pretty cool. Like a choose your path, but like get to the border. This looks pretty interesting, actually. Road 96. I'm with it. That looks kind of nice, actually. That looks like a different thing. You're planning a tournament. Wait, you're planning on hosting a tournament? I probably won't enter because there's a shit ton more than... like, there's like 80 tournaments going on right now, but hey, that's still cool. Is it like a specific tournament thing style, or is it just like a normal hosting? It has its own launcher. Oh, it's a website. That's right. Okay, that's what it is. You're right. You're right, 100%.
Everyone,
right.
Welcome back to the Game Awards. And before we went away there, I meant to tell you that was a look at a new Rogue coming to Rogue Company. So make sure to check that out this holiday season. All right. Well, you'll probably remember this next developer from a few years back.
I haven't been back in the Marvel game. Yeah,
you
just get back into Marvel, bro. Everyone's on
Parsec.
There's like a shit ton of fucking tournaments going on.
He wanted to give us a new look at his next game. Here is
I spoke with all the Supreme Lords, our leaders of all the Marvel Discords. 5v5
up,
best
Jeff?
Marvel
so
Discord
nice
will win. Cool. Okay.
See,
I'm that I would definitely like to watch for sure.
Our next
yeah, this guy I fucking
two.
Love this guy.
Trust me when I say this. Hazelight's next co-op only experience, It Takes Two, is going to blend narrative
it takes
and a
two.
Huge variety of gameplay.
I still need to play a way out.
And today we're going to have a gameplay reveal. A word exclusive. I know you like word exclusive.
I love the Game Brothers, by the way. So, like, this is the same studio
anyway,
that made that.
We're also
so.
Gonna have something that we had in A Way Out. We call a Friends Pass, which means you buy one copy, you get one copy for free. No.
Shout out to this studio still doing that. If I buy a copy, I could give it to somebody else so that way we could do co-op. Fucking shout out to this studio for doing that.
Goodbye. Boom.
I love this guy. I fucking love this guy. It Takes Two. Okay.
This is the story of a magical kingdom. One of wizards and warriors. It's an epic tale set upon the high seas. An odyssey through time and space! Pew, 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 pew! It's also a bit of a winter wonderland, bobsled sort of thing, you know?
I know about this book being the mascot, though.
Did I mention the big explosion? Hold it right there. Look at these dolls.
Wait, what is that?
Used to be humans.
Oh, that's what I'm about to say. It's like, it's so different from what they, well, I would say it's so different, but they just did Brothers. So like that art style is like somewhat cartoonish.
Of Cody and Meg.
Why'd you look like a blob of clay?
Wanna change back? Then you need to fix your relationship.
All right. Okay. You know what? All right. I'm with it. All right. You got me. You got me. I might want to play this for sure. I love the studio already. I wasn't so sure because of the book thing, but I'm with it. I'm with it 100% now. 100%.
This is a story of attraction. You feel it?
But oh yeah. Obama, Marlon Pye, Ray Ray, Jayco. Oh, so yeah, basically all the warriors. Got it. Cool, cool. You're gonna get Nebby level 3 for sure. You are. At least you know what you're getting yourself into.
Okay. I got this. Give
book with a butt chin. I hate this. The book, yeah, I'm not a fan, but I'm already with it now because of the studio and the premise now. This is like the only studio that I know that like emphasizes about like couch co-op.
How comes you get all the cool gadgets?
Because I'm cooler than you, Cody.
Oh, that looks cool.
Just me and you. Yeah.
What are you doing?
You're not feeling it?
No.
Okay. You're entitled to your own opinion.
Wow, that's actually kind of soon. All right, I still need to play A Way Out first, so that's gonna be a while.
What an absolutely crazy game! Joseph showed that to me last summer when I was.
Yeah, something like that.
Show this off. There's so much gameplay there. Thank you for that, Joseph.
Honestly, right, those the studio's games are really not that long. You could beat Brothers in a sitting if you go through it. But that's a single player, which you like control both characters with the sticks. A Way Out is by two people, and you have to have a second player to play. And it seems like this one is the same idea. No, I have it, but I haven't played it yet. I do want to like have somebody to couch co-op with me to stream it for sure.
Absolutely.
Yeah, absolutely. I know. Yeah, I know it's a nice game. I hear it's fantastic. So at some point, I will buckle down and get somebody to play with me for sure.
During my time at Nintendo,
I just don't know when I really want to do it.
Gaming for the masses, and we pushed that agenda with Wii.
Man, Reggie left right when Nintendo was like gonna go even worse. So
today, approximately 1 billion people around the world experience some form of disability that makes gaming challenging for them. This award was created to highlight the efforts throughout the gaming industry to make software and hardware that enables games to be played and enjoyed by the widest and most.
Reggie actually went to the same high school I did, by the way.
Because
so
gaming.
Even more personal attachment.
Here are the nominees.
No Witcher 3. Accessibility. You really want me to fucking play Witcher 3 super bad. I know at some point I will. What the fuck was that? What was that? Reverse Spider. It's the best game ever? I don't know about that. Have you ever played Tetris? I mean, nah. But, yeah. I'm still debating on if I should go through like the old games first. I really don't know.
And the award goes to
6 Feet Apart, of course.
The Last of Us Part 2.
Oh, fucking hell. I'm so tired. I'm so tired of Last of Us Part 2. How?
I'm Matthew Gallant, and this is my fellow designer and neighbor, Emilia Schatz. And from everyone at Naughty Dog, we would like to thank you so much for honoring us with this year's Accessibility Award.
Thank you as well to the Game Awards for choosing to.
Oh, is she in the studio?
And to all the other developers.
Oh, she's. I thought she was like standing outside his house, games. like okay. That looks a little weird, but I can see like with the reflection, she's actually just in like a studio booth.
We know how one small design decision can unlock the entire game for a player. Games are special for their ability to
like pitch
your
coat outside, stay 6 feet. We only got a bedroom apartment.
Engagement with narrative that is unrivaled in other apartments.
That just looks so off, but whatever.
It's up to us to ensure that everyone can experience that.
COVID things, something like that.
We want to
yeah.
thank our terrific group of accessibility consultants, and we'd absolutely could not have done it without your insight and your detailed feedback. Thank you.
We'd also like to thank our partners at Worldwide Studios, our senior producer, Sam Thompson, the user experience research team, and our dedicated accessibility QA testers. And we'd also like to thank everybody at Naughty Dog.
I thought they could have done something better.
This was truly a team effort, and every department had a part to play in removing barriers for players with disabilities.
I don't know what they did to help with disabilities, so I guess like I can't really judge them for that, like them winning the award.
Stories from players who were able to experience The Last of Us Part 2 without assistance, using our accessibility features to remove barriers that would have otherwise excluded them. From both of us, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Congratulations to Naughty Dog. Such an important category, and I'm proud that we're able to recognize innovation and accessibility here at the Game Awards. We're going to do that every year moving forward. This next world premiere gives us our first glimpse at next year's big adventure for The Elder Scrolls Online. Enjoy.
Oh. Okay. Oh, man. You went back to Skyrim. What else could you do? Aside from not work on Elder Scrolls 6. Alright, there's an Argonian. WoW is better? I'm certainly inclined to believe you because I played Elder Scrolls Online when it first came out. And I hated it. I'm not saying it's the same now, but... well... are you doing Dark? No, you're not doing Dark at all. You're doing Oblivion? Yeah, there it is. There it is. There it is. Gates of Oblivion. Yeah, I remember everyone loving Oblivion. Don't you guys love Oblivion?
Mobile gaming has had an incredible year.
You guys love Oblivion, right?
Revealing the winner of best.
Come and play Elder Scrolls Online.
LG Wing,
all right.
The world's first
enough.
5G
enough.
Swivel smartphone, powered by Qualcomm Snapdragon. And later, the
yeah, the
first
combat
wasn't
that for sure. It's just
from Among Us. The Game Awards.
I certainly hope that
right
the combat
back.
Can be improved for Elder Scrolls 6, but with the way that Fallout's been with 76 and Fallout 4 and all that, I'm just not. I'm not really too hopeful. Unfortunately.
Let's cross it together.
Remember, like one of the biggest draws to the Google Stadia was that Destiny 2 was going to be free to play on it. Except that it was free to play on everything else, like the week before that was announced. Stadia problems. Stop, yo! There's so much memes with fucking Skyrim and Oblivion and shit. One of my best friends growing up in high school, I went to his wedding. He every like week we're coming back to him like, yo, how far are you in Oblivion? He's like, yo, there's so much in Oblivion. I'm like, what could be so like a lot into a game that you didn't beat it yet? And then I played Skyrim, I'm like, oh, that's what he meant. I would have gone back to play Oblivion, but like It just feels like it's like a downgrade, right, like then. As far as like how Load it up. Feels, but I don't know. I feel like if I'm gonna go back to play it, I would want it to at least be on PC so that way I could get maybe like some mods in there to like have it feel better. Because I remember like trying it, just not really feeling it. But then again, that was the same thing for me when I played Skyrim for the first time. And it took me like 3 tries to like really like sink my teeth into it. And then once I did, I fell in love. So maybe I might do the same thing with that. Begin your journey for free, huh? Oh, yeah, don't let us get excited for a Star Wars thing anymore. You remember Star Wars 1313? Like, it was gonna be the coolest fucking game, and then they canned it. And then we got Star Wars Battlefront instead. At least Star Wars Fallen Order is really good, from what people have said. I've seen a full playthrough of it, so. I kind of wish I did it, so that way I could have given it a try to play myself, but. Maybe if it's like $10, I'll just play it, so that way I could actually feel the game myself. Only VR game I like is VR chat. Apparently, Hardassass had gotten the Oculus or whatever it is, just to play the Half-Life game, because that's basically like the Half-Life 3 that everyone was for, even though it's not really, but it's the best thing they got, so apparently that's worth it. Oh, I still need to play this.
Go now.
It's the biggest problem with this game already is that it's only on Switch. Like, if this game was like on PS4, it would, you know, run better, obviously. But because it's got the limitations of the Switch, it's like,
tonight, go to
no doubt it has like performance
problems.
To get
one of the fastest internal SSDs on the market, the SN850 NVMe SSD with heatsink.
What'd you say? What did he call me? What did Jeff Keighley just call me? He says an SSD. Neato. You're gonna buy it right now? Yeah, you just got all your PC parts. Yeah, go ahead and get this.
We've just heard from our friends at Pokemon Go that there is
another
surge
of
Looper appearing.
How do you have anybody at Pokemon Go?
Another Looper watch. Bring out your phones and get to catching. And if you haven't
go onto Pokemon Go unless there's a Treecko right in front of me. If there's no Treecko right in front of me, you can go fuck yourself.
And makes earning XP easier for everyone.
Treecko is the best Pokemon hands down.
In the Kalos region, like Chespin,
if it wasn't him, then I would say Haunter.
Froakie are also making their Pokemon Go debut. There's also a lot of bonuses happening now, and it's
they still hold it on
the
ship for a month.
Play Pokemon Go.
I thought they were gonna show some Pokemon Go stuff. I was gonna fucking lose it.
I've always known you would come.
Oddworld, yeah. I'm not a. I don't know about Oddworld, but apparently it's a classic.
Do you know why you have?
It was announced at the PS5 reveal or something. So good for Oddworld fans, I guess.
If you are to face what's coming, you must find your full voice.
A lot of bright lights there. Those cutscenes look good though. PS5, Epic Game Store, and PS4. Yeah.
To present our next award, she's a host and producer from IGN and your host for the Game Awards pre-show. This is Sydney Goodman.
Oh my god, you're away from the Instagram stage? All right.
Mobile games were once defined by their limitations. In a way, we celebrated the games that excelled despite their platform. As technology has closed the gap, releasing on phones is no longer
Fortnite's
a limitation.
Not going to be on it, I don't think.
It's an asset. It's never been more apparent than tonight, where the nominees for Best Mobile Game have found massive audiences because of their
platform.
I'm going
to vote for Geometry Dash.
Here they are.
That's the only phone best game that I play. Game. Presented by LG. And hell, I don't even play it on phone anymore. I just play it now and then on PC. Yeah, Among Us. Yeah. You're the best mobile game too. Call of Duty Mobile. Yeah. Wow. Fucking, I forgot this existed. Holy shit. Ah, oh, Gadget Impact's gonna win. Weeaboo. Yeah. Go. Night. I know what the fuck you. I know what the fuck you voted. Mass us. Pokemon Cafe Mix. What the fuck's that? You can bake Eevees?
And the game award goes to Among Us.
Yeah! It's too easy! At least we get to see them again.
Oh my gosh.
That makes me happy.
Again, game awards and everyone who voted.
You played on PC and PS4, leave me alone.
And congrats again to all the other games that were.
You may as well play it on PC now, eh?
We originally designed our game Among Us to be played on mobile.
Does everything
devices.
Just transfer so over on Gadget friends, Impact from PS4 or whatever to PC if you switch between them? Or is it like a dedicated save?
Wanted to create a fun experience to be
no, they didn't show the map yet. No. We didn't miss it.
Whoever.
I'm assuming it's going
to
be like soon,
because
why would it take longer than now
at
this point?
Without you. Whether you played Among Us when it was mobile, local only, or played for the first time just yesterday.
You got to start over?
Thank you for
oh, that's,
four of us.
That's kind of ass.
Again,
you would think that it's like
on
a email thing to keep it together, but then you may as well just stick to one platform.
All of this.
You're fine playing it on both? Well, if you spend money, then that sucks. But.
And a big thank you again to our friends.
Your main sub is on PS4?
We
okay.
Miss you. Thank you for being so supportive. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
What, does it run better on PC or is it basically the same?
Congratulations to Among Us, second win of the night. Next up, the Monster Hunter franchise is coming to Nintendo Switch in 2021. This is a new look at Monster Hunter Rise.
Oh, that's right. That's what it's called, Monster Hunter Rise. I still need to play Monster Hunter World, damn it. Man, Capcom's got like some shit. Fucking ghouls and ghosts in the arcade stuff, and now more showing of Rise. Nobody knows why this happened. Man, Capcom really loves their IPs, except for fighting games right now, don't they? It's so much more better on PC. I figured. Yeah, but it's not like it's a game you could beat, right? It's just like you keep getting quests constantly, like a Skyrim type thing. So I guess if you already have like all your shit there, you may as well just keep playing on it. I would just like, honestly, like if I didn't spend any money and my progress was already on PS4 and then I played on PC and I felt the difference like immensely, I would have just started brand new. I would have just left it behind. But you already spent money on, cause right, you had to spend money for the PS4 copy and like the PC copy is free, or like the Steam or the website version is free. Until you run out of quests? Yeah, so it's like a Skyrim thing. All right. Got it. Okay. Yeah, that was just a regular trailer. That was nothing.
All right, over on Twitch, the next poll is for Content Creator of the Year. Vote now for who you think is going
to
win.
Yeah, I checked the content creators that are on here. I like only know like one of them.
But next up, he's one of our industry's great performers, and he plays Joel in The Last of Us. Here is Troy Baker.
Wow. Nolan North and Troy Baker being here.
One day on the set of Last of Us Part 1, Neil, our writer and director, asked me and Ashley what we would have been if we weren't actors. I thought about it for a second and replied that...
Remember, he played Joker in one of the Batman games.
Singer. Ashley just shrugged.
And guess what? He's Nova and Kanji Tatsumi.
I would have been an astronaut.
Troy Baker's the best.
Neil incorporated parts.
And he's also Nathan Drake's brother in Uncharted 4.
Space.
The list goes on.
Became major elements of their stories, creating touching.
Troy Baker's the best,
them.
Dude.
One of those moments.
You just play for loot boxes, basically. Oh, wow. Okay.
Incorporated Neil's story as well. Not as a writer, but as a father. It involved a song he would play. And
wait,
sing
what?
Every night. That song.
Brother.
Games, Future Days.
Yeah, Nathan's mom.
One day, Neil asked if I was comfortable playing
what?
It in a scene he was writing for The Last
that,
of Us
that
Part
would,
2.
He would have blown me away still, probably, if he was
nervous,
Nathan Drake's mom.
I understood what that song meant to Neil.
Yeah,
and
mom,
to the game.
Mommy dear is Troy Baker, huh?
And the truth is, Neil can play that song better than me. But nobody can play it better than the person that wrote it. From Seattle, performing Future Days, here's Eddie Vedder.
He's got that silky voice, man. If I ever were to lose you, I'd surely lose myself. Yeah, I'm going to get DMC'd for sure. Dear, I'm not bound by my goodbye, Twitch channel. Try and sometimes you'll succeed to make this man of me. At least he's a really good singer. It's a nice guitar, too. I've no need for any more. I believe, cause I can see our future. No, he is really good. Shit. One of your videos to take it down on YouTube? Did you save it at least? Because at least one of my videos was taken down and then I re-uploaded it. But I had to, like, mute a certain section. It was actually in Persona 5. Back when I was feeling yeah, a lot of my shit was muted, too. Yeah, okay. It's a good thing that I have it, like, I'm recording this, too, so that way, just in case, like, you know, it gets some weird shit, I could always just go back to my recording and then change it if I need to. But... no one wins, but somehow they're still played. All the missing. It was like 3 years ago? Oh, okay. They may die, but in us they live. Oh, I believe. Yeah, I believe too. And I believe, cause I can see. I was about to say, wait a minute, what did I pay Valve $21 for? Oh yeah, I bought Hades. Alright, damn it, stop reminding me. Fucking hell. Thank you for your Steam purchase. Yeah, that makes sense. Since it's on sale, I may as well, and, you know, whatever. Yeah, what up? I've met them like Doris. I actually like the bass in the middle. You bought Hades just to let you know for $21. And 71 cents, yes. I saved 20% off its original purchase. So like $4. By the way, I don't know if you can tell, but when I got up, I actually got a new chair. So that people can see, it's like, what happened to your old chair? That chair was so fucking... By the way, I'm really so sorry for people that donated for, like, the PC and got, you know, helped me get the PC. And also, like, the extra money left over went towards that chair, that blue chair. I'm really sorry, but that chair was a fucking mistake. And I actually feel super bad. Like, I really want to just give the money back, like, to Major Hagar and... I think Knight, you gifted subs too, and Hardest has some shit. I actually legit do feel bad. But I got this chair, and it's so much more comfortable, and I'm not killing my back over sitting on that wretched chair. Yeah, PSA. Those racer chairs are ass. I can't say about, like, some of the other gaming chairs. Like, some of them actually do look super comfortable, and actually, like, I would want to sit in them to see. But most of those ones, I guess, just are trash. So fucking, you're better off with just a fucking Staples chair or some shit. This, I don't even know what brand this is. I literally just got this off of Facebook. I went to someone's house and got it, like, for $30. Fucking feels like it's brand new. Doesn't, it's just fine. Pick up a guitar. Fuck that shit.
Yourself and write a song for you.
Wasn't it like
one.
A gaming chair? It was the RS RCX racer
nice
chair
or
some
part
shit.
Of this,
I have to go back to specifically find it, but just in general, don't really look for those if you want really want to sit on a chair like that. The only one that I like legit thought was like interesting, like that would actually want to give a shot to sit on, and it might be worth the money because it does look comfortable. I forgot which one this one's called.
Doesn't get better than that. Thank you so much, Eddie Vedder, for being here on
the Game
Awards.
Let me see if I could.
All right,
here we go.
Here's another brand new game to show you for the first time.
It's not specifically this one, but it's this brand. Let me see if I can find the specific one. So it's another Flying Wild Hog. Why does that sound familiar? Oh, here we go. Sooner or later. Is this fucking Call of Juarez? No, it's not. We got demons.
No, it's not. All right. I thought it was going to be another Call of Juarez game.
It's that one. It's the Secret Lab brand. This one looks like it's actually super comfortable, to be honest. But there's maybe some other ones that look good, but the price, not justified. Just get a fucking office chair. What the hell's happening in this trailer, by the way? I'm only just watching it. Evil West. PC, PS5. That looks kind of cool as far as like a, you know, CG trailer. I would definitely want to see like what the gameplay is though.
There you go.
Not my ass, Chief. It does look comfortable though. Like, yeah, that $400 price tag though.
And the Twitch audience.
You're better off getting like a monitor for $400, honestly.
44% of the vote they think is going to win. So the award for content creator.
I just have some Bluetooth chair my parents got me. Ooh, I wonder what that one would look like.
Use Adobe Creative Cloud to create tributes to the nominees. You'll see those in a minute. And we've also got announcements from Among Us and Fortnite. But right now, Scarlet Nexus is an upcoming action JRPG from Bandai Namco. Here's a look.
Yeah, Scarlet Nexus looks great. So I'm actually kind of interested to see what this is. I want to play this and Code Vein. These are also by Bandai Namco.
The virtual brain link cable will now be connected. This will hurt much more than it did in training. Be strong.
Yeah, this looks super dope. SAS cable connection. I'll probably play Japanese dub. I want to like listen to some of the English though first before really making that decision, but most likely I'll play the Japanese.
Good. Seems like you're okay.
Yeah, just give me different weapon designs and like ways to kill shit. And you're already getting like me interested. Use the red strings to save the world. You didn't see this? This is a Bandai Namco's game called Scarlet Nexus. They showed this off like maybe like 4 months ago, 5 months ago. Don't underestimate me.
Don't bother resisting. I will obtain the red strings.
I wouldn't let that happen.
That sounds like you're a Lorenthal. Two different experiences. So wait, Mecha's one. So wait, if you play as both, like boy and girl or whatever, like the MCs, like they actually have different like outcome. Xbox One. Oh, I guess it's an Xbox trailer. This is coming to PlayStation, by the way. It's just, I guess, presented by Microsoft this time. And they didn't have the fucking logo, so.
For me, I am.
Genshin Impact does the same thing. Yeah, but that's not made by an actual talented studio.
Of depression,
I don't know if they are talented or not. But it's Bandai Namco. They've already made shit tons of games that are already like that, so. I'm just. Look, all I'm saying is one of them is based in Korea and, like, made by, like, three people, and the other one's Bandai Namco. Just saying.
It started for me 12 years ago. I became really interested in this idea of creating experiences as a way of improving brain function. And this relies on a principle called neuroplasticity, the fact that our brain reshapes itself and modifies itself in response to challenges. And so that's how it all started for me, to create a video game that was carefully designed to challenge and reward the brain.
They already made that. It's called Brain
way.
Age. You're a little late on that one, buddy.
It just happened a couple of months ago. The FDA cleared Endeavor RX as a medical device to treat inattention in children that have ADHD.
Hey,
this is the
never
first
mind.
Time ever that,
that
the
was
FDA
a joke I said.
A video
but
game
no, never mind. The FDA
condition.
Fucking approved this as like
right
a
now,
way to help kids with ADHD.
Prescribed,
wow.
Just like we prescribe pills for
that's
conditions.
Actually okay,
and
no, again, fucking claps. I made a joke just to be funny, but no, that was actually nice.
The world is a dangerous place.
Yeah, I don't follow Getcha games, bro. No matter if they show Weeaboo ass or not. Clearly, I'm not touching it, so
plan.
You here to be white as his? All you need to do is awaken your devil trigger. So stab your father's sword into your chest, and you should awaken it. Threat.
Join the elite. Bring the thunder.
Or you could just throw nails off of a statue, and then you'll be able to lift enemies in the air, and then you'll change your coat to red, and then you'll have your short hair white on top of that too. And then they say not in a million years, but oops, that was before that.
And it can be yours.
Transcend humanity.
Look, I'm just saying, all you need is your own rebellion, literally and figuratively. This is going on for a long time. I thought this would have been over by now. Wait, how could the Game Awards not be done? We didn't do sports. Madden didn't win yet, so we need to wait for Madden to win. Forgot. God, how are people still buying EA games now? Fuck, man. No, not fuck sports. Here's the thing. Fuck sports now.
I would go over and
show you, but the best sports game of all time, fucking NBA, NFL Blitz, sports game, but it's an arcade game. Other best sports game of all time, NBA Street V2. Fucking, again, more arcadey, but still a sports game. Hell, you can even say like a Madden game, like from old school, like Madden 07. Guess what? Good ass game. They're not good games anymore. Because they own the fucking thing now, so. See, Madden 07 was nice.
You just saw EA Play is available now.
That's what,
on
dude,
consoles, Steam, and
me and
Origin,
you had the exact same
Star
one,
Wars,
so.
Jedi Fallen Order, one of our nominees tonight, and a great game. All right, now on to one of the biggest games this year. It was created by three developers in Seattle, now four. You saw them. They've won two awards tonight. Interslot, they absolutely took over the internet with Among Us. Well, they sent us something special. This is the reveal of the brand new map.
Let's
for
go!
Among Us.
Let's check go to Among Us map. Can't believe we have a fucking world premiere and it's Among Us. I love it. Oh, you, Brett's watching. Oh, look at how sus. Look at how sus that is. Top hat, I guess? Or top hat? Wow. I'm an idiot. The airship. Yeah.
Welcome, recruit. Get yourself acquainted with the layout of the Toppet airship. Enough slacking. Go do your tasks.
Oh, you gotta yank garbage out? Clean rupees?
To certain areas.
Oh, yeah! Yeah!
Quit grouping up. Choose a room to start in.
Why did I just get so excited for a ladder?
Someone keeps trying to sabotage
a new animation!
Their plan. Keep your eyes peeled. We definitely have an imposter here.
Oh, what the? Whoa! Yeah! Ah, early 2021? Oh, man.
Right,
fucking got Cyclops laser
surprise.
Beam. Dude, I legit, I got fucking excited
a
over a ladder animation.
Right now on Twitch for the next 30 minutes. That's right. The Jeff Keighley mask. Have fun. Don't be sus. They came to me and said, all right, we can do this. One of my
Jeff
request.
Keighley mask?
Anyways,
oh, it's a good thing I'm not on Twitch then.
I'm
like, fuck that. No thanks.
All right. He's a hilarious content creator with over 25 million subs and over 13 billion views. He's joining us now live from the UK. Jacksepticeye. Hello,
I actually like
Jack.
Jacksepticeye.
What's up?
I'm not following him or anything, but like
Hello,
anytime
Jeff.
Like he's
How's
there,
it
actually does
Hello,
bring a smile
at the
to
Game
my face.
Awards.
I actually
in
do
a
like
year
him.
When so many of us were separated from our family and friends,
he actually
one
helped.
Thing remained the same.
I don't know if you remember this, but he actually helped with another content creator at KH3, one of their events, show off Toy Story. Do you remember that?
Us all
I don't know who the woman was, but I remember Jack being there.
Here are the nominees for content
creator
of the year.
Content Creator of the Year, presented by Adobe.
I don't know if I know any of these guys, though.
Are you proud of me, Dad? What
oh, this
is
the, yeah, this is the one
face.
That, yeah, I don't know. I don't know who that is.
Wait, hold up. Wow.
I don't know who this is
either. Wow.
All right, this guy's winning. I've seen the memes.
Yes,
I did! Matt Piggy!
Oh yeah, this is the one that's always in like those Among Us videos. I don't know who that is. Like, aside from that. The guy Tim though? Yeah.
The game award goes to
That dude, yeah, he's got memes.
Valkyrie, congratulations.
Thank you so much to the Game Awards for nominating me and to all of my friends and family and fans and my loving community for being so supportive of me the past 7 or so years of streaming and now to being Creator of the Year. That's crazy because there's just so many amazing creators. I can't believe, I don't know. It's just unbelievable. Anyways, thank you so much for the support. I am very flattered and honored to accept this award. And yeah, thank you.
Adobe salutes the nominees for Content Creator of the Year at the Game Awards and all gaming creators around the world.
No, not tonight, to discredit her or anything. That's not the thing. Downloading a but free trial wow. Adobe Creative Cloud at TGAX.com. I'm just really surprised. That's all. Creating. No XQC though. No, joining fuck him. Right actually, I don't know him like that because I didn't follow his Donald shit. But Mustard, no, he Donald is like legitimately like make like
it's a yearly tradition.
Not ruining people's Fortnite lives, but like season, he is like actually like an us. Asshole. So,
oh,
no,
man. So I don't. Awesome no, to be here. I'm not. So mm-hmm. awesome to see you. This not is a fan amazing, of that. Jeff. You did this yet again. So yeah, I was so excited right now. New season has started.
Oh, you don't know this? You don't know this?
With our favorite model.
You don't know this.
And what that's done
or you do, and you, you know what? It's fine for anyone to like who they like, right? I'm just saying, it's not cool to be an asshole consistently and actually, like, sure,
we've already
fair
seen
enough.
Several characters.
You know what?
In, and we have one more
fair. Everyone can change, right? I don't mind that at all. I'm just saying that he's not on the list this year for a reason. That's all. Yeah. And then we have this, so, you know. I'm watching a fish slurp scooter. Yup. This isn't new, by the way. This was teased. Or, not teased, but this was leaked.
Master Chief comes to Fortnite. You're getting them all, Donald.
Isn't that crazy? Like, Master Chief is just one of my most favorite characters ever in anything, and I'm just
why is Master Chief your favorite character in almost anything?
Join the ever-growing cast of characters in
who
Fortnite.
Says that?
And the coolest thing
the
is,
the Chief is not really a
tonight,
character
in Fortnite. You can go and
any
and
of the Halo Reach
Master
protagonists
Chief.
Are better than the Master
some
Chief.
More Halo coming as well. I heard.
They have more
yeah,
exuberant
so
personality
think,
than Master Chief has ever
right
done.
There.
They
so
do that for a reason
else,
for the blank slate,
should,
so that way people
out.
Can like grow more attached to them personally.
Well, hello, sir.
Oh, of course, it's Red versus Blue.
Hey, Sarge, did you hear? Oh, I guess you already got the news.
What news?
Master Chief is coming to Fortnite.
Well, Fort what now?
It's only one of the most popular video games in the world, but more
wow,
obviously,
they sound so
it's
old
where
now.
We are right now.
Huh.
Wait a minute. If you had no idea that we're in Fortnite, then why do you have a cardboard cut out of Master Chief?
Perfectly regular reasons.
Whoa. You guys new around here?
No! The Chief got eliminated by a sneaky blue!
That's no blue! That's Ninja! It's such an honor. I'm a huge fan of yours on Twitch.
Twitch? Is he twitching because he's blue?
Stop making us look bad in front of Ninja! We're Sergeant Griff from the popular web series Red vs. Blue. You probably watched it about 10 years ago. What are you doing here?
Well, it's more than just the Chief coming to Fortnite. This map is too. It'll be in creative mode starting at 10 a.m. Eastern.
Blood Gulch is coming to Fortnite?
Oh, so that's what we're doing in Ragnarok.
Okay.
You mean bait.
That's cool. I'm the fact that they're
sure
bringing the map in
else.
And Fortnite doesn't
either
do
way,
maps.
You can start reliving your favorite Halo memories here in Fortnite and maybe add your own personal touches to the map.
Hey, wait. Does that mean we can have dance battles? Come on, Ninja. What do you say?
Save it for New Year's.
All right, I'll give it that. The
Red
fact that Blood
Blue,
Gulch is
Donald.
Okay, that is cool.
Yeah, isn't that so awesome?
Bringing the map on
it's
top
so
of that
funny,
too, that's
Adam.
That's
so
the neat
awesome
touch
about
for
that
sure.
Is that,
I'll give him that
Blood
credit.
Blood Gulch was recreated in Fortnite Creative by
Blood
this
who?
Awesome creative
yeah,
team
uh-huh.
called themselves Atlas.
It's
creative.
Only basically like
and
Halo 1's most popular map.
At 10 a.m. Eastern.
Only it's only that.
You'll be able to
no,
go
no,
into Fortnite,
not a huge deal.
And you can play Capture the Flag in a recreated version of Blood Gulch.
Oh my god,
it's gonna be fun.
Everything is in Fortnite right now. So are you done for the season?
You know, I mean, Agent Jones is actually just kind of getting warmed up. So
yeah, they took Kratos. They have
thing that
oh.
we should show you.
Oh great, is it Nintendo?
Thanks, Donald. I have no idea where we're going next, but I'm on board.
Thanks, Jeff.
All right, Donald Mustard from Epic Games. All right, come up in a moment. Keanu Reeves is going to present the award for Best Game Direction. We've still got a few more surprises. Don't go anywhere. Right now, let's hear from Rocket League on their new season.
Hey, what's up? This is Cascade, and I am stoked to be welcomed into Rocket League's vibrant community in such a big way. I'm excited to work with Cyanix and Monster Cat.
Of course, Walking Dead and Fortnite.
Music season 2. Starting tonight, you can get the featured anthem in the item shop and grab my free banner all weekend long. Let's check out the season 2 trailer featuring my brand new track that I made just for you guys, and I call it Flip Reset.
That dude is so hip. Yeah, I really need to fucking buckle down and, like, play a lot of Rocket League. Rocket League is actually fucking fantastic. It was a Simpsons joke, actually. But they made it into a game, so. Yeah, that looks like a Fortnite car. The Fortnite car. Oh, I'm sorry. The Rocket League car is coming to Fortnite. Oh, God. I legit, like, am. Oh. I'm legit, like, wondering, like, what could be, like, next, like, legitimately. What the fuck, Skyrim? Oh, okay. I was about to get a fucking heart attack. Oh, I couldn't handle another Skyrim update or some shit. Oh. Oh, man. Yeah, that new game Haven actually looks pretty cool. I also need to play Titanfall 2. I would say Titanfall 1, but Titanfall 1 doesn't really have a story mode, so I feel like I'm comfortable with just going into Titanfall 2. Yeah, this is that Haven game I was talking about. It feels like it's like 11 o'clock, but it's only 9:30. Holy shit. Ah, this was the game I was playing at PAX. The guy that, the team that was behind fucking Shovel Knight. They're actually working on the Cyber Ninja game. There's Cyber Soldier or something? I don't know. I also, in the future, will be going into the Yakuza series. streaming them, obviously. Let me just see for reference, like, how long it takes to beat, like, the first Kiwami game.
Just checked Pokemon Go on my phone, and there's Wooper everywhere. Oh, so we can officially declare another
Yakuza
Zero.
Yakuza Zero first, and then it's the Kiwami game.
And at Pokestops, Yakuza. And you can save Shadow Wooper from their villainous clutches. Make Wooper your buddy, take photos of it with Go Snapshot, and battle with
wait,
it
why am
in
I going
Go
reviews?
Battle
I
League.
Just put time to beat.
If you're enjoying Wooper Watch, you'll
love
Pokemon Go.
It says
December
main story is 30 plus hours, and with
and
extras,
to
it's 66
to
hours.
See how many Wooper have been caught. All right,
I kind of expected
Wooper
it to be like a 40-hour game, so. All right, that's fair. Oh, whoops, I didn't mean to do that. Just Cause Mobile. Oh, it looks like multiplayer. Okay, never mind. Yeah, that doesn't even look like Just Cause at all. It looks like the Call of Duty Black Ops over the top over game. No thanks. I don't know. I never even tried any of the Just Cause games. What the fuck? Oh, fucking Fallout 76. Speaking of which. Yeah, updates have changed the game, huh? More like updates is the game. Because it wasn't even a game beforehand. How are they going to get people to come into Fallout 76 with all that shit? Oh, now I gotta get the Scribe of Avalion. Oh, man. Uh-oh. Okay. I'll just wait until after this is out. Well, then again, should I mute it? Because maybe like they might do like a sound effect thing. You know, I think I'll be fine. Let's not look. Okay. I wasn't even reading that, so yeah, good luck.
We've got a lot of great show. Keanu Reeves still
been
to
bad.
Come, Christopher Nolan, and so much more. And, of course, we've got the Game Awards sale happening on all the platforms, including an awesome discount on Destiny 2. So make sure to check that out across all platforms. All right, for the next 30 minutes on Twitch, you can get a free cosmic wrap for Fortnite. There is a Twitch drop happening right now, so check that out, too. This next game was announced last year right here at the Game Awards, developed by Airship and supported by Riot Forge. And now they're back to give you a
Ruined
first
King?
Look at the gameplay.
Oh, this is the League of Legends
indie
shit.
Title,
okay, okay.
The first ever single-player
right.
console game from the League of Legends universe. This is Ruined King, a League of Legends story.
See, I'm all with like the doing like an expanded thing for League because honestly, like, a lot of the heroes do look really fucking cool. So to actually, like, put in a story behind it is actually a neat idea.
Monster.
And, of course, the League of Legends are making a fucking
when
fighting
live
game,
in
so.
Bilgewater, you see some things.
Let's start the party.
The Queen of Bilgewater, looking to bring order to this twisted town.
And stay down.
Priestess of the Great Kraken, unmoved by fear.
This is destiny.
The legend, whose strength is only eclipsed by his kindness.
Feel better now.
Oh, I thought it was just like one character. Well, I guess they have like a shit ton, so they may as well like make a single player thing with like a lot of them.
Dishonored swordsman fleeing from his past like the wind. And a nine-tailed fox who devours the essence of her victims.
Delicious.
I see no fortune for those standing in
the. It looks like, Diablo. But then it has, like, turn-based shit, so.
can't match my blade.
Can't help but wonder what brought them together. Nothing good, I reckon.
It might be cool. I mean, if it's like story driven, then, you know, I might be interested. So PS5, Xbox, it looked like Steam and Switch too.
All right, Rune King, available on console and PC in 2021. Now to present our next award, a man who absolutely needs no introduction. Please welcome Keanu Reeves. Keanu?
Jeff, thank you.
He's cut off the hair, okay.
I'm honored to be here to present the Game Award for Best Game Direction. This category recognizes the studio that demonstrated superior
creative vision. Dude, this guy's a fucking vampire.
Setting an even higher bar for the entire gaming industry. Over the past months, I've come to really appreciate all the fantastic creativity that goes into making a video game. A special shout out to the folks and team at CD Projekt Red and Polo.
Yeah, the biggest buggy mess launch since fucking
Johnny Silverhand in Cyberpunk 2077.
What was that other one? That was like super bad. That was like a AAA title.
And now, here are the nominees.
Oh wait,
for best
Fallout.
Game direction.
Oh man. It's not as bad, but man, I feel bad.
This is a one-time gig. When it's done, we're done.
Huh?
What we're doing here is
it's just showing the awards. No, what's
Samurai? You are the ghost.
I swear to God, if Hades wins again. Hades winning is a fucking meme right now. Game direction.
And the game award goes to
Hades, I guess?
The Last of Us, Part 2. Congratulations.
Yeah, well. How did this happen?
Thank you, Keanu.
I thought everyone
that's,
hated this game.
That's a real thing to say. Shout out to our game directors, Kurt Margenau and Anthony Newman. Wish we could be doing
Man,
this together,
liberal,
guys.
Ugh.
Man, what a year.
Yeah, exactly. What a year.
It's an honor
You're
to be in
winning
this category
everything.
With such incredible games.
So how did this happen? Like, well, not that how did this happen?
Excuse me,
that's not the right question.
Internalize it, make
how,
it their own, and turn it
how
into
do they
game.
Do this? Like, do they send them like their awards?
Have such
like
an
after the fact?
Because
they clearly don't walk up to win,
partners
like
Sony,
to receive the award.
Every
so
single person.
I'm assuming they just ship
on,
it.
This game
I don't know. Man, do not
and
fucking raid that FedEx
thanks
truck.
To my former boss, now partner.
You won't find a PS5, nor will
you
find an actual game award either.
While we made this game, I can't tell you how much I appreciate that. Thank you to the Game Awards.
Who let this
and
happen?
To all our fans.
That's a good question, cheers. Too. I guess it was the critics. They probably got paid enough
congratulations,
to
Neil.
Send all their employees
all right,
to like double down on votes.
One last award to present
some
the big
shit.
One, Game of the Year, presented by Christopher Nolan. And we'll also have a tribute
Nolan,
to all
so
the nominees
weird.
Performed by the London Philharmonic Orchestra back at Abbey Road Studios. Game of the Year is coming up next. But right now, GTA Online continues to evolve. And next week, they've got their biggest update yet.
Just give me San Check Andreas 2. Or no, I'm sorry. No, wait. I was about to say Vice City 2, but that already
is
happened.
This the right place
so yeah, San Andreas
party?
2.
Can we post? Is there a hashtag?
Man, people fucking love this
We're
shit,
all
don't
here
they?
Because of one man.
You're not on the mainland now, huh?
Anything goes.
I've seen him gurning like a trout, chasing some supermodel down the beach.
Honestly, like out of all the Grand Theft Autos that I played, this one feels like,
lots of guards,
like for 5 specifically.
Security.
It just feels like it's
it.
The one that's like the least
you're obviously
in touch
going to
with Grand Theft Auto.
Submarine?
I mean, I'm not saying online. I'm just saying like how 5 was for me. It was just so much fun for GTA 3, the little bit that I played of that. GTA San Andreas, GTA fucking Vice City, GTA 4. All of those just felt like just I could do whatever the fuck I want and just like have the most fun. For 5, for some reason... Anytime I wanted to just, like, do whatever I wanted, it just felt kind of, like, chore-ish. I don't know.
Lucy Adam was born about 9,000 years before our time. In the year 515, after having federated the African continent, she set out to conquer Rome. It was on witnessing the consequences of this terrible battle that she decided to impose upon
what
her people
happening?
A strictly a vegetarian diet. And it's in 1082, following the unexplained death of the king, that she was crowned Empress of Spain. It's in fact to celebrate this event.
What is happening? Rock and what roll is this?
Was invented. In 1789, allied with the valiant Japanese, she discovered the real Indies, which had fallen into the hands of the bloody French.
I'm
this
legit.
This was followed by the Great Devastation.
Confused.
A 100-year war that Lucy Adam ended before beginning the Great Reconstruction and establishing a lasting peace by banishing all forms of currency and violence,
as well as the use of selfie sticks in museums.
Lucy, are you with us?
Oh, is it just like a commercial?
So for next week, don't forget your essay on the cultural stereotypes of the great civilization. How far will you push humankind?
We've been having fun with Instagram's Game of the Year AR effects. Here
we
are
have
a couple
not.
More.
We have not.
Those effects are still available, so keep posting to your Instagram reels. And coming up, we'll find out who's getting
like
a
trying to get houses or cars. You
got to
spam heists and jobs
year.
Like an MMO. Yeah. You're right. It's like, oh, do I really want to go and like cheat code my way to get everything? No, but how do I get it legitimately? Oh, you have to basically play one way. Oh, okay. Right. This Medal of Honor?
Shit. How bad have things gotten?
VR Medal of Honor?
Has turned every neighbor into a possible enemy.
Yeah! Whoa! I fucking joked!
We need more resistance members.
I was joking!
Much easier said than done.
Drop your weapons. Make
it looks terrible, but wow, I was joking.
Please tell me you brought bazookas.
This is not Medal of Honor either. Do they even remember what the fuck Medal of Honor was?
Okay.
I'm at a loss, actually.
We had to report for the draft.
It was something we had to do.
Jeez, dude. This was brought on like... Oh, this is such a sad thought. There's soon gonna be people that weren't around in World War II anymore. Like that's fucking nuts, man.
We all know it's going to be a tough job ahead.
Did Modern Warfare get announced yet? This is definitely not the place for fighting games. Hell, fucking One Punch Man was fucking nominated to win Fighting Game of the Year. So you think they're gonna announce a fighting game here? No. And yes, this is VR. So, you know, perfect. I don't know, man. Yeah, let's go fucking get riffs, please.
Welcome back to the Game Awards. I'm so excited about that Medal of Honor for Respawn.
You're not excited for Medal of Honor.
Surprise,
no one has
right
been excited
now
for Medal of Honor since the PlayStation 2.
I can't wait to play that hopefully this weekend. All right. When the show ends, the game
you're not playing it this weekend. You're
going to
be playing
Festival.
Hades.
You can play upcoming games and stream them.
Hell, I
game
might be playing
now,
Hades this weekend,
no downloads
actually.
On PC, Mac, or phones. Make sure to check it out. We got playable games available all through the weekend. All right. We've got one last world premiere to share with you. Check this out.
One second.
We know now that in the early years of the 20th century, this world was being watched.
Oh, we're just about to get into the 10 p.m. mark.
Roger, copy.
About like another 15 minutes. So I'm assuming that it might be done by then. Because they have just Game of the Year, and then they're going to show the Philharmonic again. At least as far as I don't think there's any more awards. Is that Mass Effect?
Is anyone receiving this? We've lost contact.
I think I recognize like that ship thing that like teleports you like warp speed or some shit. Oh. Yeah, never mind, I don't think so. Elden Ring! No, I'm just kidding. Oh, wow. You have got to be kidding me.
Where BioWare is going to take that next.
You have
very exciting.
That is a fucking joke.
Award. This man has created some of the most iconic films of all time, some of which screened this summer in
that
Fortnite.
Is,
and on December 20th,
I'll be sitting down
for a conversation
that
with him
is
on YouTube
funny.
To talk about the home release of
funny.
Tenet and his illustrious career. And if you've got
questions
for him, which I'm
Mass
sure you
Effect
do,
will
send them
continue.
Our way using the hashtag
AskNolan
on Twitter.
Okay.
But right now, without further ado, to present Game
right.
of the Year, it's my honor to introduce
There's nothing else to announce,
Nolan.
So...
Hey, Chris.
There's nothing else to announce.
Thank
I'm just going
to
see like what the Game of the Year is. And then...
I've always been interested
in
telling stories that immerse the audience. I like movies that unfold in unexpected ways and pull people into a world.
Mass Effect will continue.
I see a lot of parallels.
But we threw it in the trash.
How a player's agency and choice intersect with more traditional storytelling methods. It's exciting to see and really quite groundbreaking. Tonight, all six nominees for Game of the Year are true masterworks in immersive.
I voted for Doom Eternal.
Please
off of this
welcome
list.
From
Abbey
Road Studios, the London Philharmonic
I
Orchestra,
think,
conducted
honestly,
by my old friend, Lorne Balfe.
Like, I would be fine with Hades, Doom, and Ghost of Tsushima. But FF7 will probably make it. It's a little bit... It might be a little bit too much considering that it's only a PS4 game. So, maybe not. It's probably fucking Last of Us. No, I know, but like people really fucking love this game, so. No, Doom does not need an orchestrated version of their soundtrack, so please. The faster you stop this song, the better. It needs heavy metal, for the love of God. Man, that fucking boss fight was so stupid. Remember when I flipped out last time and it was fucking Sekiro? I'm sure at some point I gotta go back to fucking play Sekiro. I mean, I will, but... I don't know, man. I want you to win, Hades. I legit actually, like, I want, like, memeing and shit, but I legit want you to win. Out of all these other clowns, sure. Let Hades win. To be fair, this is, like, the only indie title that is, that's on the Game of the Year list. So, gotta keep that in mind. I forgot Animal Crossing. No, I know when it came out. I just forgot it existed. Game of the Year, though? Man, people fucking love Animal Crossing. I don't get it. Alright, Philharmonic, you had two songs. Nice job. You did it.
Well, that sounded fantastic. And now, the Game of the Year award goes to...
It's Last of Us.
The Last of Us, Part 2.
Please, Brett, I'm done. That's enough. Alright. Don't look at the screen, by the way, for anyone who's wanting to watch.
Again, big congrats to all the other games we're nominated with.
So whatever you're ready,
everyone at Naughty Dog.
I can't wait
to hug and high five and get drunk with each one of you. That's going to have to wait till next year. I want to just thank every person that worked on this ambition game and within Naughty Dog and outside. Shout out to our Sony partners again, Scott Rohde, Connie Booth, Herman, Pulse, Sean Layden, Jim Ryan, your support and trust in us.
Who doesn't
want to
see
world.
It? Don't look.
And more than anything, and I know that I speak for the whole team when I say this, we'd like to thank our friends and family.
Don't look. Yep. Do not look. Yep. Okay.
It should be a full screen button. Like
yeah, I clicked it already. I'm waiting for this damn thing at the top to go away.
Just move the mouse away from the screen.
And wait for how long, because it's still there. No. Now it's if I pause it, it shows up again.
Okay. So then
here, I'll just put a tiny little bar covering the top so you won't see it.
Yeah, do what you want.
All right, one sec. You got tape or something?
No, you know what? Just
you know what? Here. I'll just stand right here.
Is the thing there?
I need something to cover it real quick. Is this good enough? No, that's
Don't move, don't look. You could just like have it play and then like I'll just sit down when it's ready. Is it really that big of a deal?
Yeah.
I mean you scream, but I don't know if it's really that big of a deal. I mean what could be better than
Okay, are you ready?
Play it.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Come here and sit down and then hit space. Alright. Ready. 3, 2, 1, play. Just keep it there. Until that goes away. Okay, we're good. What are you sitting here for? Dude, that would actually be really fucking cool to like add a story mode, like extra piece, but. Fucking Virgil.
Sephiroth. They fucking did it!
Kono toki o machi wabita zu. Saa, Nantou ni zetsubou o okutte yarou.
His sword is so fucking big. This seems like unfair. At least, you know what? This really does, like, this makes so much more fucking sense than Sora at this point.
Yep. And we got another villain.
Oh, are you kidding? What? Oh. Yo, fucking stop. This also means more music from the FF7 remake. Oh, shit. Wow, stop. This trailer is ridiculous. That, yo, holy fucking shit. Yeah, he looks like shit right there. And that, like, he looked like really bad. Yeah, that's the Advent children leaving. What? That's gonna be his final smash. this month.
Yeah.
Wow.
Fucking go.
Wow. Well, that's fucking ridiculous. That's the first time I saw it. I didn't get a chance to see it. Thank you, Dez, by the way, for hosting. That was my first time seeing it. I didn't get a chance to see this because I was doing my top tens. And then I heard Brett fucking yell at the top of his lungs. I'm like, all right, well, they did something. But I did not expect that. Holy shit. What was that form? That was, I know this because I've seen it just off of hearsay and just everything. That form was like his final form before going to like the final showdown with Cloud. So like that is like legit a form that he did in the FF7 game. So no, it's not. No, this is not. This is not going to make me play Smash. Like this will make me play it like just to see like what his moves are and like how cool he is or whatever. But this, like, now I feel like I absolutely have to play FF7 like someday on the stream. There are a lot of like mods on the original like PC version. So like I'm thinking of doing something like that in order to add to more like just to make it easy for me and shit. Well, not easy, but like better for my experience, I guess, for the first time. So that's what I would fucking do for that. But I feel like now this solidifies. Yeah, maybe I should just play FF7. So we'll do that, I'm sure, at some point. What if Sora was in? I don't even want to know like what I would have done to my own setup. I legit probably would have fucking like, I've screamed at the top of my lungs for very few things. Joker in Persona, like from Persona being in this game too, was one of them. I don't even know what it would have fucking happened. I would have fucking lost my shit. I legit thought it was like the cut was like very Virgil-esque, but you could have definitely seen it like with Cloud being there too. It's like, that was certainly a hint, but DMC5? Well, yeah, if Virgil was in it, I would have fucking lost my shit too. But why would Virgil be in it before Dante? You know, like, it would have been a double, like, character reveal. Like, that would have been kind of nuts. But, nah, man. All right. Well, that was the Game Awards. Fucking Last of Us 1. How in... I legit don't understand how that won. Like, not if it's a good game or not, whatever, I don't know because I haven't played it. But so many people were so fucking upset. But that's not the point. Sephiroth and Smash, Dead Space basically coming back with a new game, whatever the studio's title, I forget what it's all. Striking Distance, something like that? It's one of the moons on fucking Jupiter, that's what the name is called, like, the moon name. That, new Dead Space, essentially, and a new Left 4 Dead. That's fine with me. All the other shit was, like, whatever, and not neat stuff, I guess, and then sprinkled in, but, yeah, that was fine. Yes, and the Among Us map. Yes. How can I forget about the Among Us map? But the ladder! Yo, I fucking PogChamp over a ladder. Yo, dude, that's... Okay, I'm getting fucking excited over a ladder. And it's, the unfortunate thing is we don't have a date for that, so hopefully we'll get that maybe, like, within February time or some shit. But either way... thank you guys so much for this double-decker type recording I'm doing. Yeah, just about 10 o'clock, too. We're just hitting the mark that I usually end my stream on. So, thank you so much for everyone who tuned in for both today of the top 10 for the best moments. And, of course, my tier list for what happened this year for all the games I completed. And, of course, for everyone who watched the live reaction for the Game Awards. In general, it's the Game Awards, but also... really cool shit happened in the middle of that too, so that's neato. Yeah, that's pretty much it for me today. Tomorrow I'll be back with more Persona 3. I will stream a little bit earlier than normal. I will start around like maybe 5. I'll either start at 5 and go until like maybe like in the normal time 10, or I'll start at my normal time and then go a little bit later because that hour I lost during that session, I do want to gain that back, but I don't want to do it off camera. So we will be doing that tomorrow. And Saturday, I'm thinking of going into another Among Us session. So if anybody wants to play Among Us, try and fill your schedule or free your schedule up. Because I want to play with people that actually do know. And hopefully we can get some people in there. But if not, I'll just have an Among Us session with randoms too. Because I just want to play it. or I might play Hades. I don't know. All right. Let me see if there's somebody that I can... that I can raid, because usually this will actually end my recording session. But thank you everyone so much for tuning in. This will be the end for the recording, but I appreciate everyone who watched, and Sephiroth is back. Back in Smash again. All right, whatever. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. That'll at least be the end of the recording, but thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you again.